row, Northwestern State has left the bayous of Louisiana for the mountains of Idaho. Last week in Boise, Northwestern State conquered Boise State 22-13 in the first round of the NCAA 1AA playoffs. A Scott Stoker to Foy Turner pass got the scoring underway, and Demon defense did much of the rest. After chalking up playoff win number one, Northwestern State learned they'd have to fly home only to return to Idaho 5 days later. This time, Moscow, Idaho, 300 miles north of Boise and home of the number one team in the country, the Vandals of Idaho. Idaho had taken care of Montana in the first round, 38-19. At 10-1, the Vandals had avenged their only loss. Quarterback John Freeze, three touchdown passes, and Bruce Harris with two rushing scores. So while the number one Vandals get to stay home for a second straight week, Northwestern State continues its tour to Idaho. They'd also like to continue winning in Idaho. The Demons are used to number one teams this year. They've already beaten two others. The Vandals vow, though, they will not be number three. It promises to be a great matchup. Northwestern State's option versus Idaho's passing game. Defense against offense. Next live from the Kibbe Dome in Moscow, Idaho. Today, from the Kibbe Dome in Moscow, Idaho, it's the quarterfinals of the NCAA 1AA football playoffs. The Demons of Northwestern State of Louisiana, 10-2 on the year and champions of the Southland Conference, against the Idaho Vandals, Big Sky champions, and 10-1 on the year. Outside, the sun is shining, but it's only 35 degrees, a 15-mile-an-hour wind, so everybody's happy. This game is being played indoors. The number one-ranked Vandals against the eighth-rated Demons from Northwestern State, live from the Kibbe Dome in Moscow, Idaho. Of course, the quarterfinals of the NCAA 1AA college football playoffs. Good afternoon, everybody. Wayne DeZubak, along with former Seattle Seahawk linebacker Larry Pilowski, and welcome to the Palouse country of Northern Idaho. It really is the passing game of Idaho against the speed of the Demons from Northwestern State, Larry.
They are fast. The Demons from Northwestern State have speed on the outside. They have fast backs, their quarterback. Everybody on this team has good team speed.
Boy Turner may be a problem today. Has a problem with a cartilage in the knee. He will play, but he may not be at 100% strength. If that's the case, then you got a guy named number eight, Al Edwards. This guy can really fly. When, you know, you talk about guys like Ben Johnson, he doesn't look too far over his shoulder to see this guy with 10.47 speed and 100 meters.
Two big play receivers right here, and they will make the play for Northwestern all day.
You can't stop John Freeze. You can only slow him down. Nobody stopped him, but you can slow him a little bit.
The guy has less than a 300-yard passing game. You think he's had a bad day, but he's led his Vandals to a 10-1 record.
And, of course, the big bad Vandal for the Vandals is Marvin Washington, number 90, defensive end. He's made 21 tackles in the opposing backfield.
In the last four games, Marvin Washington has finally realized his potential as a defensive end, and there hasn't been anyone that's even come close to stopping him.
Well, this is the fifth straight game that the Demons of Northwestern State have played on the road. Will they be road weary?
I think they might be a little bit road weary, but they seem to be pretty relaxed, and they played well in Boise last week, so I think they're ready.
And believe it or not, they're excited to be back in the state of Idaho to play in the quarterfinals. We'll be back with more as the Demons and the Vandals getting ready to kick it off right after this. And that's the fact that last week both picked up their first ever 1AA playoff wins. Of course, it was the Vandals beating the University of Montana, avenging their only loss of the season. And 300 miles down the road, Northwestern State beat Boise State. The final there, 22-13.
Two teams here, I think, that match up really well, too, Wayne, in the way that they play the game. Northwestern is a little bit more run-oriented, but they're very disciplined. They run that option offense that's so hard to defense for a team like Idaho that hasn't seen it all year.
They've seen it only once.
Exactly. And Idaho, with all the tools that they have offensively, there's no way, as you said earlier, that you can stop them, but you can slow them down.
The two coaches of this game, Sam Goodwin from Northwestern State, you see both I've got one win in NCAA postseason play. Keith Gilbertson for the University of Idaho. Gilbertson taking over 3 years ago with a 27-8-0 record has really done a job here for the Vandals. Well, we're ready to go. Thane Doyle will kick it off for the Vandals. Dennis Smith will be deep for Northwestern State. He'll be joined back there by Kevin Lewis, number 5, to the right of your screen. The winner of this game will get the Marshall Furman winner. With 11 minutes to go in that game, Marshall leads Furman by a score of 9-7.
That game being played in West Huntington, Virginia. Well, live from the Kippy Dome in Thane Doyle, a freshman from Spokane will kick it off. Dennis Smith will take it at the 1 yard line. Foot actually was on the goal line. Has a good wall right up the middle on the outside. Lots of running room. And he is stripped up by Richard Carey at the 35-yard line. Else why he may have gone all the way. That was a great kickoff return. Offensive line, as you can see there, pretty good offensive line. Not really big as offensive line goes. In fact, that's one of the big differences. The Big Sky team here, the Vandals, a little bit bigger than Northwestern State. Scott Stoker will start at quarterback. Kenneth DeWitt, what a speedster he is. Pete Ellis, great game last week against Boise State. They come out of the I formation with Scott Stoker barking signal. Stoker, the pitch out to DeWitt. Breaks one tackle, still on his feet, into the Vandal territory at the 46-yard line. A pickup of 13 yards for Kenneth DeWitt.
What makes this option play so difficult is if it can get outside the defensive linebackers. And you see Roger Cecil there lets the outside man get beyond him, and that will kill you in the option every time.
So it's a first down on the first play. The ball at the 45-yard line of the Vandals. Gilbert Galloway now in a quarterback. Sam Goodwin will do that. He'll use three different quarterbacks here in the first half while he gets things underway. Pitch it out to DeWitt again. DeWitt doing it all by himself. Charlie Oliver finally brings him down. They mark it at the 42-yard line, so a gain of three. Idaho defensively, Brutus, Zeller, Smith, Washington, Cecil, and the two Medved brothers. In the backfield, not a bad defensive backfield. Oliver, Carey, Smith, and Place. Second down and seven. Anthony Mason in there, one wide receiver. Mayfield the other. Stoker back in at quarterback. Looking for Mason. Great catch by Mason over Richard Carey at the 10-yard line. First down for the Northwestern State Demons.
This little play action pass off of the fake dive. You see the option action here. And then Stoker just takes a couple steps backward. He really sells the fact that this is going to be the option play. Then that little drop back, it is meant to confuse the defensive backs. Richard Carey plays good coverage, but just can't outleap him for the catch.
And he was one-on-one. He was looking for some help from the free safety, John Place. But you saw number 18 a little late getting there. Ball just outside the 10-yard line. So first down and 10 from the 10.5. Northwestern State didn't take very long to get in there. Stoker keeps the ball up the middle of the 5-yard line. Stoker, not a big player, but a quick player, makes great decisions. As you see, he's only 5'8", 157 pounds.
They really give this quarterback the opportunity to make the reads on this option play, too. He's got all the control over what goes on with that play. And Stoker, being 5'8", I would say 5'8". I don't think 5'10", we'd have to stretch him out a little bit to reach out.
Second down, about 6 yards to go. Handoff up the middle, the fullback. Pete Ellis gets it down to about the 3-yard line.
Ellis, a 5'10", 196-pounder. Nice low center of gravity. You love that on an option fullback to be able to send that big guy up the middle.
Ellis comes out. Mike O'Neill comes in to replace him. Didn't take the Demons long to start threatening here. An explosive team. They average over 400 yards a game offense, and it's pretty even. About 200 both ways. Al Edwards to the near side on third down. They have to get to about the 1 foot line. O'Neill wrapped up in the backfield by Cord Smith. It'll be fourth down.
Coming into this 1988 season, the Vandals were a little worried about this defensive front. But Cord Smith has played a whale of a season at the defensive tackle, Marvin Washington at the defensive end position. And Cord Smith at that nose guard off tackle position has been very effective getting into the backfield.
So Keith Hotnett will come in, set it up at the 10-yard line. 20-yard field goal attempt, apparently, anyway.
Keith Hotnett, number 21.
On a fourth down and three. And Hotnett puts it right through. So the Demons march right down the field, score first. And with 11:38 to go, first quarter, Northwestern State 3, Idaho nothing. The Demons, a Northwestern State a 3-0 lead here early in the first quarter with a 20-yard field goal. He's a senior from Belle Chasse, Louisiana. 11 minutes, 38 seconds to go in the first quarter, and he'll be kicking it off. Richard Geary and Ryan Smith will be deep for the Vandals of Idaho.
Two dangerous return guys, either one. You probably want to keep the ball away from Richard Geary if you can, and they try to kick it to Smith, and he'll take it.
So Smith takes it at the 1-yard line. Threads his way to the 19-yard line, and then nothing but white jerseys, and there may be a fumble. At least the Northwestern State Demons feel so. We'll wait for the official. He says no. So the Vandals will have it at the 19. If you were ever worried about the Demons being a little down from all this travel, they've got their emotion level up sky high, don't they?
And there's some great hitting that goes on this kickoff coverage team. You can see there the ball did seem to come out, but they marked the ball dead there, and the Vandals will take it over.
So the Vandals on offense, led, of course, by John Freeze. 21 touchdown passes this year, over 3,200 yards passing. We mentioned it in the pregame. You can slow them down, as Montana did when they won the game 23-17 back in September. But still, he led the Vandals to 604 yards in total offense. Freeze standing in the pocket all day, throwing deep for Casey Dunn. Dunn has it. Saving tackle.
No being conservative for the Idaho Vandals today. You know, this is the kind of a situation where it's do or die. You lose this game, the season's over with, so they're letting it air out. Casey Dunn, a perfect strike, 56-yard gain for the Vandals.
First and 10 for Idaho at the Demon 24-yard line. As you look at the offensive line, which has done a tremendous job all year, the receivers, and John Freeze, the most valuable player of the year in the Big Sky Conference offensively, has Bruce Harris in the backfield. First down and 10. Harris gets it. Shooting around the outside. Tackle made by Leonard Parker, the leading tackler for the Demons. Parker coming into the game with 126 tackles. Defensively, it's a good one. Now again, not a big team. Idaho does have the size advantage in this particular ball game. Hilliard, a great defensive back. And, of course, Dennis Smith, the free safety. He's had a great year. Not to mention the job that Mark Nystrom did last week against Boise State. He was a single-handed wrecking ball.
He's one of their big play guys, number 49 at that linebacker.
Underneath they go to David Jackson. Flips the tackle. Mark it at the 5-yard line. First and goal to go Idaho.
With John Jake, number 7 for the Vandals, being a little banged up the last couple weeks, David Jackson has played a very important part in the receiving core for this Vandal club. He made some clutch receptions last week against Montana, and it's starting off today.
Well, mark it back at the 6. First and goal to go for the Vandals of Idaho, the number 1 ranked team in the country. It's 10-1, trailing here 3-0, coming up on 10 minutes to play first quarter. I'm Wayne DeZubac, working with Larry Polanski today. Welcome to the Kibbe Dome for this 1AA quarterfinal playoff game. Freeze. Checked off again. In the end zone, wide open. John Jake touchdown.
John Jake had to improvise a little bit. That play took a little longer to develop than John Freeze would have liked, but he had all day to throw the ball. Then John Jake finally finds a place, opened up. The free safety, for some reason, lets him go in the back of the end zone. And you can see that John had been looking around, and there's Jake all by himself.
6-yard touchdown pass to John Jake. Dane Doyle will come on for the extra point. It's 6-3 Idaho. And this game has started off like a cannon going off. Doyle's kick is good. 10:03 to go. First quarter, 7-3. The Vandals lead the Demons. Leading at 7-3, a couple of big pass plays. Both teams threatening early, scoring early. And now Idaho kicking off either to Al Edwards, number 8, or Dennis Smith, 35 on your screen. It's going to come down to Edwards. He keeps backing up 2 yards deep. He'll bring it out. Edwards out to the 20-yard line. Was made by Scott Dahlquist, a tight end
And let's take one more look at this touchdown pass, 6 yards from Freeze to Jake.
Watch Jake again in the back of the end zone all by himself, and the free safety that some reason checks off, and you can see guys back there talking to each other, Steve Compton saying, what happened here?
Well, Furman has beaten Marshall. The winner of this game will play Furman next week. 13-9, Furman over Marshall. First down, Scott Stoker, quarterback, pitching it out to Paul Frazier. Frazier slips a lot of people and gets out of bounds at the 36-yard line. That will be a first down and a gain of 15.
Looks like a busted coverage here by the Vandals because there's nobody on the pitch man. Look, he's just running free. If they expect the free safety to get there and make that play, they're going to be in a lot of trouble. John Place had to come all the way from the middle of that formation to make that tackle.
Great run by Frazier as you look at Keith Gilbertson, the head coach of Idaho. Frazier, just a sophomore from Coushatta, Louisiana. Coming out split to the near side is Mark Mayfield. He's going to see a lot of time in this game today. Turner kind of hurt, but he's in there as well.
Pitch out to Frazier, fumble. Picked up by Medved on Marcus Pack at the 32-yard line. He cannot advance the ball. It'll be marked at the 31, Idaho's ball.
A lot of things can happen in this option offense when you have to make the pitch. And one of the resulting factors in a lot of cases is the fumble. Last week, 8 fumbles when they beat Boise State down in Boise last week. Fortunately for Northwestern, they only lost 2. They've lost the first one here today.
Jim Medved, number 41, with a fumble recovery. And again, as I said, Mark back at the 31. 7-3. Idaho leads it. 9:42 to go. First quarter.
Very dangerous position on the field to give Idaho the ball. They have good range in Thane Doyle, who's pretty consistent from 40 to 50 yards in the field goal category. And with this offense, this is almost like giving him points.
Bruce Harris, the lone setback. Triple receivers to the wide side. Harris down to about the 29-yard line. He's stopped by Leonard Parker and a couple others.
You'd be real impressed with this Northwestern State defense and the way that they run to the football. Always 4 or 5 guys on the tackle, and you can hear with our sideline, Mike, the kind of intensity in the hitting department going on down there. There's some good wax being laid.
Good look at John Freeze. 2 years in a row, all-conference first-team quarterback for the Big Sky, and he's got another year to go. Second down and 8. Throws underneath, complete. That's good for a first down to David Jackson at the 19-yard line, and you heard that ball hit the pads of David Jackson.
Number 22, David Chitman, on the coverage for Northwestern State. But the velocity on this ball is something you can only imagine if you have to try to catch something like that. It just embeds itself in your body.
Well, you heard it that time. There's a flag down, by the way, and they're talking to Northwestern State, so the Vandals are going to be called for holding, I believe. Wipe out that
holding on the offense. Repeat the down.
So forget the first down. Ball back now to the 39-yard line.
This offensive line has done a great job all year long in protecting John Freeze, but they haven't had the holding calls too often. We haven't seen a lot of holds against this real veteran offensive line.
It's been together really for like 2.5 years. If you take a look at how it shapes up. Second down and long for Freeze. Going to a wide open John Jake. And gets out of bounds on Lewis. First down at the 16-yard line. Kevin Lewis was there. Jake was there. And basically they didn't know what to do with each other. So they ran out of bounds.
Well, and Jake's banged up too. He's got a really badly bruised shoulder that he suffered a couple of weeks ago in a game down in Boise. And you see here, Lewis, the coverage man, just slipped, fell down, and John Jake was all by himself. And he doesn't want to take another lick on that shoulder, so he headed for the sideline.
Well, so much for a second down and long, and now it's first down and 10. They mark it at the 17-yard line. So Idaho leading it 7-3, threatening again at the 17 of the Demons. Bruce Harris to lay handoff. Harris scoops through to the 6-yard line.
Randy Hilliard with the tackle. And Hilliard took a pretty good pop from Bruce Harris. who's been quieted just a little bit in the running department in the latter part of the year. Started off averaging over 100 yards a game the first six games of the season, and he was slow with an injury, but looks like he's running pretty well today.
Yeah, Bruce Harris, gain of 11, has 17 yards on three carries, and it's first down and goal from the seventh. Breeze now, 4-4 passing for 98 yards already. Damon Daniels in the backfield. Daniels has it down to the three. Tackled from behind by Thistle. Sidney Thistle, a senior from Jonesboro, Louisiana.
If the Vandals have a power running back, Damon Daniels is the guy you have to look to, number 32, to carry the ball. He's the big, tough guy that'll take it right into the middle of the line. What's great about Damon, too, is he has good hands and he can also run outside, so he's got the best of both worlds with him.
Second and goal to go. High formation. Casey Dunn in motion. Bruce Harris down to the one. Again, Furman has beaten Marshall today 13-9 as you look at Sam Goodwin on the sidelines looking at his demons trying to hold the Vandals here at the one-yard line on the third and goal. So the winner of this game will play Furman next week at a site to be determined. Inside sources, though, kind of indicate that whoever wins this game will play at Furman. We'll see.
We've heard that rumor from two or three different sources, so when you hear it from that many places, normally it pans out to be true.
Well, the Vandals did not draw as good a crowd as they had expected here. It looks like it's going to be around 6,000-7,000. They were hoping for 10,000-12,000. It's third down and goal. I formation. Bruce Harris over for the touchdown. Getting up.
No fancy smancy plays here. They just take a drive block right up the middle, lead the fullback, give it to the tailback, let him hurdle into the end zone, and he just barely gets over.
Harris still on the turf. 13-3 in favor of the Vandals here with 6:49 to go in the first quarter. And Bruce Harris has been averaging better than 74 yards a game rushing, and if you would lose somebody like him, it would really hurt, because last week the Vandals lost a runner named Devin Pierce. And Pierce, although he'd only had 300 yards on the year rushing, he is one of those guys that when he comes into the game, averages 7-8 yards a carry.
An explosive runner, a guy that can break the long one for you on a play that seemingly is going nowhere.
Well, Bruce Harris is still down, so we'll take timeout. 6:49 to go, first quarter, 13-3. Idaho leading 3. Idaho leading Northwestern State. Wayne Dzubak with Larry Pulowski. Welcome to the Kibbe Dome in Moscow, Idaho. Quarterfinals of the 1AA playoffs. Boyle puts it through. Bruce Harris, by the way, was helped off the field. Looked like he was more just kind of out of wind. Somebody may have hit him in the belly with a helmet or something. We'll take a look at the touchdown again in a moment, and we'll see if we can see what happened.
When you take off airborne like this, you expose the ribs in the midsection very easily to a helmet. And you can see he left with, he had his left arm up in the air, and he probably did take a helmet right in the ribs or in the stomach. And he walked off the field on his own power for the most part.
He got bent over like, he got bent over like a pretzel that time there down the bottom of the pile. Maybe something like that hurt. Right now, you're not looking at a bunch of happy demons. They're kind of laughing. They said that they came into Lewiston, Idaho, which is about 25 miles to the south of here, on the plane the other day, and they said it was a controlled crash landing. They said it was really just bumpy, and I don't know how true it is, but one of the coaches was saying the plane came down on the right wheel and then went back down on the left wheel. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't want to have anybody worried. But at any rate, they were laughing about it. They lived to tell about it.
Well, when you fly through these mountains here in the in the northwest or central Rockies or whatever we're in here, it gets a little turbulent now and then. And Lewiston down in that valley, it's a little interesting to fly in and out.
We flew in last night, and we knew that our pilot was an Air Force pilot. We could just tell by the way he was doing it.
No nonsense kind of guy. Just get it, get in the plane, let's go.
14-3, Idaho leads it. Payne Doyle will kick off. Again, Al Edwards and Dennis Smith deep to receive for the Demons. Dennis Smith backing up. At the two. Again, a great wall in front of him. And look at Smith put on the speed. How out to the 27-yard line. Just a heads-up play there by Mitch Swenson to stop him. It was a good open field tackle because Dennis Smith had a head of speed up.
Watch Mark Matthews, number 57 for the Vandals, come in and bust up this wedge. There's another Vandal player that gets in there too. This is a great looking return. Look at the Vandals. They take all the interference out of the way, but there's still a pretty good hole for him to run through.
Down by 11 now. The pass just thrown out of bounds. Too much pressure. Good thinking by Scott Stoker. He said, hey, this play is not going to work. Let's get out of it and start again.
A real smart play. Idaho caught them in a blitz situation. In this play, they pull, and you can see number 55, who pulls down the line, John King. Stoker says, hey, I got no chance of completing this pass, so he just lobbed it into the first row of the stands.
So it'll be second down and 10. New quarterback again in there, Rusty Slack this time. He's the third quarterback we've seen. Hand off to O'Neill. Mike O'Neill, a senior from Shondaloo, Louisiana. 5'11", 228-pounder, gets a yard or two.
You really have to have a lot of confidence in your quarterback and the type of offense that you run to shuttle plays in with different quarterbacks. And three different quarterbacks is what Northwestern State will use during the course of this game.
By the way, Georgia Southern beat Stephen F. Austin today, 27-6. So Georgia Southern advances against either Western Kentucky or Eastern Kentucky. So we know Georgia Southern is one of the final four. Furman, one of the final four. Fumble, DeWitt, trying to get the handle. Richard Carey recovers for Idaho.
Very timely hit there by Brian Smith. As the ball was being juggled around by DeWitt, he came up and made the hit. Kept that loose ball going for Richard Carey to jump on. And again, this option so many times on this pitch play, and that's a good pitch by Stoker. DeWitt just does not get the handle. You see Brian Smith come up and make the hit, and the Vandals again deep in Demon territory.
Well, the one thing you didn't want to do coming in here was to turn the ball over, but there is a flag down as well. And it could be a little bit too much celebrating on the part of the Vandals. If that's the case, it may back them up. We'll wait and see. And again, it could be just a lot of emotion flowing out there right now. It's a personal foul. It is against the Vandals. So if there is a break for the Demons, it's that the ball will be back near midfield now instead of the 30. Let's listen to the call.
Fumble recovery stand. We have a dead ball. Personal foul against the black team. First down.
Yeah, right now the Vandals certainly living up to their name. The Demons having some problems. Last week, they thought it maybe was the cold that was causing them to fumble nine times down at Boise State, but right now they fumbled twice, lost both fumbles, and are down by 11 points here with 5:56 to go in the first quarter. So Northwestern State needs to just settle down, freeze. Underneath to Lee Allen, and Allen is corralled by Chipman, but it's a gain of about 6 yards.
This Demon team last week got very little pressure on the Boise State quarterback, and they are not putting any pressure on Freeze at all today. And if you leave John Freeze back in that pocket to set up and throw and have as much time as he wants, he's going to pick you apart. They just have too many weapons back there.
Second down, excuse me, I said six. I forgot they had that 15-yard penalty, so it's actually second and 18. So they got a long way to go yet. Underneath they go, the Slater, the tight end. He is down to the 31-yard line. So they're still going to have a bunch more to go on third down.
Chris Slater's a receiver that the Vandals use. It's either feast or famine. They either throw him the ball 8 or 10 times a game, or he doesn't see the ball. This is his first reception of the day, and he's wide open out in the flat.
It'll be third down and 7 at the 32 is where they mark it officially. John Freeze having a pretty good day passing already. Casey Dunn goes in motion. Damon Daniels, the lone setback. Here comes the blitz. Freeze to Lee Allen underneath. Great one tackle to Hilliard. Lee Allen. Missed him, and it was all over.
The blitz was coming, and the Vandal offensive line picked it up. They had seven guys rushing. You see Damon Daniels staying there to pick up the blitzing demon. Now watch this million-dollar move right here by Lee Allen.
John Free, 7 of 7 passing for two touchdowns and 148 yards. We have 5 minutes to go in the first quarter.
This guy, week after week, you don't think he can get any better. You don't think he can surpass what you've just seen. But he keeps coming up with pass after pass after pass. And that offensive line is great at this point in time.
The kick by Doyle is good. 5 minutes to go. First quarter, Idaho 21, Northwestern State 3. Back here at the Kibbe Dome, two turnovers, two touchdowns. And the Vandals now lead it 21-3 with 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Doyle keeps it low, takes a couple of hops. Dennis Smith trying to find a handle, finally gets it at the 11-yard line. And Smith, a flag flies, but Smith is also brought to the ground by Eric Hansen, and will check the laundry. You know, before the game, everybody from the Demons said to me, what we need to do is control the ball. Just take some time off the clock. That's exactly what they have not been able to do because of the turnovers, and bingo.
Take another look at this touchdown pass to Lee Allen. Again, look at the great job of picking up that blitz. That's so important when you think about a big play and a big passing play that can happen. And the other end of the coin is that leaves your defense in a man-to-man coverage, and if the man-to-man doesn't work, you're in trouble.
Well, the penalty was against the Demons. It's going to be back to the 10-yard line. Eastern Kentucky has beaten Western Kentucky 41-24. So Eastern Kentucky will play at Georgia Southern next week. So Eastern Kentucky, Georgia Southern in one semifinal. Furman against either Idaho or Northwestern State. And right now, it's not looking good for the Demons. But it's early yet. Stoker can bring this team back with a pass like this to Mayfield. Mayfield has a first down out at the 26-yard line. A good open field tackle by Charlie Oliver.
Northwestern State has not had a problem moving the ball, as we alluded to. Eliminate the turnovers and they're going to be just fine. Here's some pretty great protection by the Northwestern front. Little half roll there by Stoker, and he finds Mayfield on a, well, they used to call it the Steeler route, a 15-yard in route. And that's a tough play to cover because of the depth of the route.
First and 10. The pass almost intercepted. That time the pass from Rusty Slack was a little bit low, almost intercepted by Brian Smith, and two Vandals are still kind of getting up. They really popped heads.
Now this is where that two quarterback system is a little tough on the quarterback that has to come off the bench and throw a pass. That's very difficult. You see the coverage he throws into. It looks like somebody might have run a wrong pattern because there were no Demons in sight.
Second down and 10, ball at the 26-yard line. Yep, whistles blow. Probably illegal procedure when they stop it like that. There's still plenty of time on the clock to get the play off.
We have a dead ball, full start, repeat the down.
Back it up 5 yards. We'd like to say hello to everybody watching on KTAL in Shreveport, also on KLAX in Alexandria, KIFI in Idaho Falls, and KIVI in Boise. This game being seen in quite a wide range today here in the quarterfinals of the NCAA 1AA playoff.
5 yards.
Second down and 15 at the 21. 21-3, Idaho with three first quarter touchdowns. Two after big turnovers by the Demons. A shuffle pass to Paul Frazier. Medved will bring him down. He was also slowed up by Foy Dory. Excuse me, Eric Dickey.
Stop made by Eric Dickey for the Vandals.
This play develops pretty well. Frazier comes underneath, takes a little shuffle pass. You can see that offensive front for Northwestern just moving people around, moving them to the side, not really trying to make the big crushing block, but just screen them off and keep them out of the way.
That'll make it third down, eight to go at the 28-yard line. Stoker back into quarterback. Looking against the grain, the pass is complete to Mayfield. He has the first down and out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Nice play. Let's watch it from the ground camera.
Here's that half roll again that we've seen a couple of times already out of Northwestern. His initial receiver's not open, but he looks for the throwback to Mayfield. And Mayfield somehow got isolated on a linebacker who got lost in the dust. Mayfield just takes off down the line.
Okay, Steve Ritter is our cameraman down here. What happens to him?
Well, he's going to
He says, I'm getting out of here.
He bailed out on us.
Come on, Steve. Here we go. Stoker, again, looking. Nobody there. Now he's looking for Orland Lockhart. The tight end makes the catch, fumbles it. Idaho will have the football. Lockhart really took a hit. Mark Matthews, the man who came up with a big hit.
Matthews, we saw bust a wedge on a kickoff, and he's getting some time in this first string defensive area also. Watch the pop right there, and the ball just comes flying out. Hard to blame a guy when he gets hit that hard.
That was Charlie Oliver that made it. Matthews got the fumble. Charlie Oliver made the hit. And Orland Lockhart is still on the turf. As you can see, the problem there, you just don't have your breath.
Well, and he was basically blindsided, too. Lockhart looking back for the ball. You know, you have to give a guy a pat on the back for courage to take that kind of a hit, catch the ball, and the fumble afterwards is unfortunate, but he doesn't even see it coming. He's just trying to catch this ball, make sure his feet are down, tries to brace himself, but he can't before the cornerback comes up on it.
A senior from Metairie, Louisiana, which is a suburb of New Orleans, and he's being helped up. You'll be okay. You just lose your breath, and unfortunately for the Demons, a third turnover here in the first quarter with 3:41 to go, and it seems like the clock has been stopped for the Demons in the first quarter. And the Vandals have the football right back. And you said it, Larry, no problem with the Demons moving the football, but they cannot continue to turn it over. Three turnovers in the first quarter. And Freeze is changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Triple receivers to the wide side. Here comes the blitz. Throwing it underneath to John Jakes. Jakes splitting the seam. The ball was just a little overthrown, and that's the first incompleted pass that John Freeze has thrown this afternoon.
Well, he is human. There's no doubt about that. You wonder sometimes with the way that John Freeze can throw the ball. There you see Lockhart getting a little breath of fresh air on the sidelines, trying to figure out if he can remember which state he's in.
Well, he remembers. He hasn't been out of his state for very long.
The same one he was in last week.
Exactly. Only this time he's warm, and there was a flag down. We didn't see it. Motion penalty. I guess the Vandals will back it up into their own territory at the 47-yard line.
Play it down over. It's first and 15 now from the 47.
Go, first down, 15 for Idaho. Freeze. Getting chased. Throwing complete. John Jake gets it, and somehow John Freeze got away from the rush for almost ever before Henry Wesley brought him down.
The pocket collapses here on John, and he's finally forced out of there. You don't see that happen too often. Wesley comes up, puts a good hit on him, but he still has a chance to get the ball off. John Jake, one of his more sure-handed, in fact, the leading receiver on this Vandal ball club.
First down.
First down for Idaho. At the 34-yard line, 3:24 to go, first quarter. David Jackson comes to the near side. Damon Daniels, the lone setback. We haven't seen Bruce Harris since he was hurt on that touchdown. Throwing wide open, Casey Dunn. Casey Dunn down to the 14-yard line. Dennis Smith makes the stop. And he was looking around for some defenders. He couldn't believe how wide open he was.
Northwestern again came with the blitz, and they're trying to find a way to get to John Freeze, and they're trying to do it via the blitz. Again, Damon Daniels stays in, picks up the receiver, and the man-on-man situation is just not working out there, and Steve Compton that time was the man in charge of Casey Dunn, who's made two big catches already today.
And these blitzes are contrary to what we were told that Northwestern State would do, because nobody's gotten to Freeze with a blitz this year. Wide open in the end zone, John Jake. John Jay just flew past the secondary.
Three turnovers, three TDs. That's pretty good efficiency, I would say, by this Idaho offense.
And it's not taking them long, folks. We still have 2 minutes and 53 seconds left to go in the first quarter, and it's 27-3.
It's like a steel curtain. John Freese has to be one of the least touched quarterbacks in 1AA football. They just can't get to him.
Freese now 10 of 10 passing for 201 yards and three touchdowns in the first quarter.
And his, even his incompletion they brought back because of the penalty, so he didn't count against him.
The kick is good. 2 minutes and 53 seconds left to play first quarter, 28-3. The Vandals lead it here at the Kibbe Dome. We'll look at the touchdown one more time. Last week, you know, some people from Boise State told me, you know, we had a lot of receivers, they, speaking about Boise State, wide open. We just couldn't hit them last week, and they felt that maybe John Jake and Lee Allen and John Freese would have a field day. So far in the first quarter, that's been prophetic.
A lot of receivers in a lot of open areas. And again, when you blitz, you're playing man-to-man, and you've got a problem if you can't stick with that coverage.
Well, so far, at least the fans that are here for the University of Idaho are liking what they see. There are a few fans, believe it or not, here from Natchitoches, Louisiana, who came up to support their Demons. And they were ringing the cowbells. In fact, I can hear them now in the background. But they probably cannot believe the scoreboard as they look up. Nor can we, really. The Demons were ranked by one computer to be a five-point favorite in this game, despite the fact Idaho was the number one team in the country. We figured it'd be about a three-point ball game.
Well, one thing those computers don't take into account is turning the ball over on your own end of the field and giving the Vandals the possession three times on the other side of the 50. That'll kill most teams.
Payne Doyle keeping it low. Dennis Smith on a big hopper of the nine. And Dennis Smith is brought down by Scott Dahlquist at the 21-yard line. And a few tempers starting to flare now.
Well, it's frustrating for Northwestern right now. And the Vandals rolling right along. But Northwestern has basically given the Vandals the ball in such horrendous field position every time. The Vandals haven't had to go too far, but they've gotten there rather quickly, and there's still 2:48 to go in the first quarter.
28-3 is the score. Scott Stoker will keep it and gets a couple.
Very crafty little quarterback on this option. We said before, Stoker only 5'8", 157-pound junior out of Alexandria, Louisiana. And tricky little guy to try to cover on this option play.
Second down and six, a gain of four. Ball at the 26-yard line. Stoker, just a straight drop back over the middle of the Lockhart. He rambles up the field, and look at him go out to the 45-yard line. Orlin Lockhart.
Lockhart bouncing back after the shot that he took on the sideline. And he looks like he's okay after the run he makes on this. See a little delay route. There's Lockhart right in the middle of your screen. He just delays and releases across the middle. This is a design play all the way. And they catch Idaho's linebackers either too deep in coverage or just forgot about him altogether because he was in there blocking first.
Here's some of the Demon fans that have made the trip from Natchitoches, Louisiana. They're here today, and they're trying to get their team going. The pass, tipped and caught. Tipped by Brian Smith, caught by Floyd Turner. And it's another first down for the Demons at the 41-yard line.
A little justice here, I guess, if you're a Northwestern State fan. They've had three big turnovers here in this first quarter. This one should have been an interception. Brian Smith just can't get the handle, but Floyd Turner finds it.
12 yards, first down at the battle 42.
Brian Smith, an all-Big Sky Conference defensive back. Stoker has passed 7 for 7 for 117 yards, so it's not a case of the Demons not being able to move the football. Here's the pitch to Kenneth DeWitt. Brian Smith did a great job that time to fight off a blocker and make the tackle on DeWitt, albeit he picked up 5 yards to make it second and five.
Well, he had Al Edwards in his face, trying to screen him off from the play. Watch the late pitch here. Stoker really strings this thing out down the line. Finally, at the last minute, gets it out to DeWitt. And there's the great play by Smith and gets to hang onto the leg, two of DeWitt.
Gain of 6 yards.
the Witter Jr. from Mansfield, Louisiana. And they'll give him a gain of 6, second down and 4 at the 37-yard line. Stoker sprinting to the left. Again, Brian Smith intended for Floyd Turner, and Smith with his second near interception in the last three plays.
Stoker this time taking that short roll to the left side of the field, running against his body. Got a lot of pressure up the middle from Jim Rudess and Cord Smith.
Really put the pressure on him. KLX and Alexandria taking our game today. We're happy to have you here. Unfortunately, so far, it's been all battles here in the first quarter. Turnover is hurting, as you know. 40 seconds to play. First quarter, third down and 4. Stoker. Here comes DeWitt. Using his speed to get outside and get the first down at the 25-yard line.
As a defensive coach, it just scares the heck out of you when you see these real fast guys get that ball and be able to get to the outside of the formation. Once they turn that corner, a lot of things can happen, and most of them are bad for the defense when they get outflanked. And this is basically what happens here. A great little cutback there by DeWitt. You see the strength. Richard Carey, a pretty sure tackler. He carries it for about 4 yards.
So it's a first down at the 24-yard line. Stoker options it down to the 20. Medved made the stop. It'll be a gain of 4, second down and 6. KTAL, New Center 6 in Shreveport, Louisiana, also taking this game live today. And we've come to the end of the first quarter here at the Gibby Dome. It has been all Idaho, 28-3. The Vandals lead the Demons from Northwestern State. Welcome back to the Palouse country of Northern Idaho. Wayne DeZubak, Lori Pulowski with you. Start of the second quarter, down by 25 points the Demons are, but moving the football as they have the whole first quarter, if they can hang on to it, they might be able to get back into the ballgame. O'Neill, Jim Rudess wraps him up at the 19.
O'Neill, which you would call, I think, a fire plug back there in that offensive backfield. 5'11", 228-pounder.
Ball resting at the 19, third down, 5. Roy Turner comes to the near side. Pete Ellis now in at fullback. Out to Turner. Turner had to come back 5 yards to get it, and he's back at the 21. That pass will go for a loss of 2 yards. I thought possibly when he came back that far that he might want to try to throw it or something, because it really was a lateral almost.
It definitely was a lateral, and actually I think Stoker gets the ball back a little bit more than he probably wanted to. Floyd Turner, very heavily taped right knee. We weren't sure if he was going to be able to play in this game or not, and he came out in pregame, ran around on the knee, looked pretty good. But I don't care how good your knee is, that's a very difficult position to get out of when you have 8 bandages around.
Now, fourth down and 6 at the 20-yard line. You're down by 25. What do? You go for it. Stoker over the middle, complete to DeWitt. DeWitt, touchdown. He beat John Place, gets in for the score. And boy, did the Demons see that one.
Well, that's really a character play there on fourth down and long. Stoker with a good play action fake and a great fake there by Ellis. You saw him freeze those linebackers up there. They got into man-to-man coverage, and John Place just can't stay with the speedy DeWitt.
Podnett will come on to try the extra point. And the kick is good. So with 13 minutes, 35 seconds left to go here in the first half, it is now 28-10, Idaho. Well, there's the stat that pretty much tells the story of the ball game. We're just underway here in the second quarter, but there's a stat in the first quarter that gives you an idea how decimating the turnovers are. Larry, Idaho with 223 total yards in the first quarter alone, but NSU had 174.
Now, Northwestern has not had much trouble moving the ball. What they've had trouble is holding on to it once they've moved it. And this last resulting touchdown has to be a big moral lift for him.
Hodnett kicks it off. It'll come to Richard Carey at about the 7 yard line, and Carey on the move to the right. He gets to the 15, and that's it. Here's the touchdown again on a 4th down and 6. Stoker gets it out to Kenneth DeWitt, who makes a good play on John Plake.
DeWitt just a little bit too much the afterburner there for John Plake to stay
exactly.
up with him. Plake, not slow by any means, but not the fastest guy in the world.
Well, how fast are these guys? For those of you who don't know, they've got three guys that are the top three 100-meter runners in the Southland Conference. And you start with Al Edwards, who runs it in 10.47. And then, of course, you've got DeWitt, and you also have Mayfield. So those three guys are the number 1, 2, 3 100-meter runners in the Southland Conference. A little off-tackle play.
Last week in the playoff game against Montana, Idaho, when they got up and were ahead by a couple of touchdowns, became very conservative and ran the ball quite a bit. We were really amazed at the number of times that they did rush the ball. And this year they've been able to do that. The last couple of years, you couldn't say that the Vandals had a running game. This year they've had a very productive running game.
But again, remember, Bruce Harris has not been in the ballgame since he got hurt on that touchdown run. Devin Paris was out. This is Renee Barton, another rookie, and he's caught up in the backfield in a great play by Henry Wesley, a 6'2 senior from Shreveport.
This play doomed pretty much from the onset. The upfront blocking pretty much across the line broke down for the Vandals. You get defensive linemen running around your backfield, so you've got all kinds of problems.
Again, Furman has won. The winner of this game will play Furman. The other semifinal matchup is Georgia Southern against Eastern Kentucky. The pass out to Damon Daniels. Andre Caron makes the stop.
And here's a play we haven't seen the Vandals have to use yet today. They're going to have to bring John Plake on to do a little punting. Sam Goodwin exhorting his players on the sideline.
Exactly.
Good sure tackle there. That's a great open field one-on-one tackle. That's one of the hardest things to do in this game of football.
So John Plake will be back at his 12-yard line to punt it away. And Plake kicks up Boomer. Clark. Here he comes. Clark has some running room. And Clark bumps into his own man at midfield. John Place brought him down. There is also a flag down.
We're going to get a clip on Northwestern State on that return, but Place kicked the ball so darn far he outkicked his coverage by 20 yards.
Here's the call. So it's clipping. And just another one of those mistakes. Instead of having it at midfield, you're going to have it back at the 35-yard line now, and it's just one little mistake after the other here in the early part of this game for Northwestern State.
We have clipping on the return, first and 10.
49 yards.
It's going to be even worse than that. They mark it off from the spot of the clip, so it'll be back at the 34-yard line.
Look at, there's nobody in your frame there. You outkick the coverage by a good 20 yards. You'll see the clip right here, I think, at the end of your screen. There it was right there.
He came flying in there. It
looked like Mark Newstrom was the guilty demon.
Stoker out to Floyd Turner. A good move by Turner to get a couple of yards out of that one. Again, the Vandals reacting very well to that play.
That's a tough play to run into the short side of the field like that. You have the natural enemy, the sidelines over there, to help out as your 12th man, and it's something you have to get off very quickly to get that wide receiver a chance to have any lateral movement up the field at all.
The wholesale changes being made offensively. Sam Goodwin trying to get his team one more score. They're back in the ballgame. They need a good drive here, and they can negate that crazy first quarter. Paul Frazier trying to cut the seam. Continues to run at the 48-yard line. And he's got another first down. And there's a flag that flies as well. A little bit of hitting after the fact. Watch if you can see number 51, Jerry Medved, at the end of this play come in and hit somebody. And I think he may have been the one that got flagged.
Paul Frazier, look at the strength this guy has, carrying four Vandals with him, and you see Medved right,
right
there at the end.
Right. Boom! And he got flagged for that puppy, as well he should.
Penalty marker down on the field.
I don't think I would turn that one a cheap shot.
Yeah, that was definitely a cheap shot to Floyd Turner, who is hurting anyway with that right knee. Wasn't even looking around. He was out of the play, and the play was over.
We have clipping on the defense. First down.
Now, I don't know if I like the word clipping. I call it a personal foul, a personal mugging. You call it what you want.
First down, 10 yards to go at the Vandals 37-yard line.
Floyd Turner would like to call it back and turn time back a little bit and get out of the way of that one.
I think he's all right. Turner is okay, though. Handoff to Frazier, delayed. Look at the speed he has. Knocked out of bounds by John Place at the 20-yard line. Another first down. Pickup of 17 yards. And so far, the Vandals have not been able to stop the Demons.
This is just a play basically it's designed to go off left tackle. It's a blast play. They send the fullback up, handoff to the tailback. Frazier doing a little improvisation on his own part there to take the ball to the right side and get outside the Vandal defense again. They can't continue to let that happen or they're going to have some real problems.
Well, how many times have you been in a game, Larry? You know, you played years, I've played years, where you get up early and all of a sudden you lack that intensity that you once had, and that allows another team to get back in there. Pete Ellis up the middle for a yard. It'll be second down and nine.
There is some intensity in the hitting of this game. You can hear it on the parabolic sideline, Mike, that we have out there. Just some incredible popping and cracking going on. This is a playoff game. These guys got here for a reason. Just two really good ball clubs.
Coming up on 10 minutes to play, first half. 28-10 if you just joined us. Idaho leads it. They led it 28-3 after the first quarter. 28 points in that first quarter. Stoker. Mike Deller brings him down near the line of scrimmage. No gain. Deller wanted to go out to the outside man, but they had that pitch man covered, didn't they?
They've got the linebacker coming from the inside. He actually seemed Jerry Medved over pursue the play and run himself out of it. He has a good angle on the quarterback. But
and 2 yards.
Stoker, with all the quickness that he possesses, got back to the inside, picked up a couple. This is a rather huge third down play for the defense.
Well, I think they're going to go for it. This is two down territory for them now. They still need another touchdown, and they think this is their best chance. So third down and five in the end zone. Al Edwards wide open, touchdown. Well, you're back in it. When you get, you know, 14 quick second quarter touchdown points like that.
Stoker pays the price at the end of this play. Cord Smith, as soon as he releases the ball, will put him to the turf. You see the spin move by Smith, but it's not in time. And again, John Place trying to cover the ultra-quick, ultra-speedy receivers from Northwestern State just cannot handle that task right now.
Exactly, and that was the... Pretty much now things setting up as we thought they would at the beginning of the game. And right now, we've got a ball game at 28-17. Idaho still leads it, but the Demons have finally got back into the contest. Now the Demons sideline a little bit happier now that they've scored 14 second quarter points to go with their field goal in the first quarter, and they still trail. But it's only 11, not that 28-3 stuff we had a little while ago. 28-17 Idaho. Wayne DeZue back along with Larry Pawlowski. Welcome back to the Kibbe Dome. I'd like to welcome everybody watching on KIFI in Idaho Falls and on KIVI in Boise. Keith Hotnett will kick it off. Richard Carey and Brian Smith are deep. Richard Carey gets underneath it at the 10-yard line. Up the middle he comes. And Richard Carey will get it out to the 37, 38-yard line. Never does go down, but there's a flag down as well. Also a player is down. George Salisbury taking a long time getting up. He looks like he may have hurt an ankle.
The clip against the Vandals.
So the Vandals are going to be whistled for a clip. That'll back it up. And right now, everything's going the Demons' way, with the exception of the injury to Salisbury. Now, there's some Idaho fans who a little while ago were kind of ecstatic, and now they're biting their nails because it's an 11-point ball game.
Well, Idaho's offense needs to get back on track here a little bit. They, for the first time, were stopped on that last series by Northwestern and had to punt the ball away.
Clipping on a run back, first and 10.
So there you have it. That'll back it all the way up to the 15-yard line. There's timeout, 9:07 to go here in the first half. And our score, 28-17 in favor of Idaho. The Vandal offense starting from its own 14-yard line here. 9:07 to go, first half. Freeze stands in the pocket all day. Wesley with some pressure. Finally, he's going to be sacked. Getting in there is Mitch Rowe at the 1-yard line. And you know what? Freeze was back there like he was having a picnic.
Here's the proverbial coverage sack. The good coverage downfield by the Demons. Freeze, as you say, just standing back there, has all day long. You give a guy 6 or 7 seconds, he's got to be able to find a receiver, but there's nobody open.
Well, Rowe was taken to the ground. He was blocked to the ground by Steve Unger. And then Rowe just gets up and comes and gets him. So that's a great effort. And now at the 1-yard line. And Freeze wants it again. Here comes the thrust. Freeze to Lee Allen. Incomplete out at the 19-yard line. How Sidney Thistle did not put Freeze down to the ground in the end zone is beyond me. Watch this.
This is a 30 to the pocket in a drop back quarterback situation. Slater just gets enough of a block on him to push him outside that pocket, and Freeze steps back into that natural little open area that's always there, and that's why that is so successful.
Well, a golden opportunity here for the Demon defense. They've got the Vandals backed up to their own 2-yard line. Third down, 22 to go. That's it. Now, they should be looking at John Blake maybe to kick it out of his own end zone, get some good field position. The draw play. Damon Daniels getting some running room to the 9-yard line, but it'll be fourth down and long.
And that's exactly what they were doing, just getting a little bit more room for John Place to work with so he wouldn't be backed up right to that end line. That's always a scary situation for a punter to be in.
Daniels up to the 9-yard line.
Remember last week, I know Demon fans do, the game tied 13-13, Boise State, Northwestern State. Mark Neustrom busts through. The ball hits his helmet, goes out of bounds, and they get 2 points, and those were really the 2 points that won it for them. Let's see if they get pressure again. Place, not a good kick. Fair catch called for at the 49-yard line by Clark. And so that's where the Demons will start. At their own 49-yard line, good field position for Northwestern State, a team that really just hasn't been stopped offensively. Stoker is 10 of 12 passing for 144 yards as he comes back out onto the field. So he's not sitting here and, you know, he's not shrinking up like a violet in the light of John Freeze. Timeout on the field, though. 28-17 is our score. Idaho Legion will be back in a moment. Captain Randy Hilliard, a couple of defensive backs on the bench there along with Dennis Smith and the rest of the defense while the offense does its work. Mike O'Neill, the fullback for three. Into Idaho territory at the 48-yard line. Actually, that play worked for nearly 5 yards.
The last offensive series that Northwestern had is a real nice play selection. A lot of different types of plays. They kept the Vandals off balance a little bit. One costly penalty on Idaho 2 hurt them in that drive, but a real nice, consistent drive by the Demons. We'll see if they can put another one together.
Well, as I mentioned, Stoker's already thrown for over 140 yards. He's 10 of 12, so he's getting the job done here today. He's looking to throw again. Turner. He turned Turner around that time, and John Clay took it to him. Incomplete. It'll be third down and six. But Turner was open. Doing a little work there on George Salisbury. He's the player that was injured a little while ago. You see him working on that right knee, left knee rather.
Taping an ice bag to it, so it looks like he may be done for the day.
Sam Goodwin has drives his team back to within 11. They were down 28-3 at one point. The crowd here at the Kibbe Dome getting into it, and we've got a couple of players getting into it. A couple of 75s, Jim Rudess on defense and Sean Freeman on offense.
Dead ball, false start, offense.
Obviously, Freeman started a little bit too quick. Top of your screen, 75. There you go. Here comes Jim Rudess. Like a couple of bulls in a china closet going at each other. That's the score. 6:57 to go, first half. Stoker, straight drop down. Wide open is Mayfield. Has the first down. Down the sidelines, out of bounds at the 28-29 yard line. Boy, a third down and 10, and you pick up 20. And a flag goes down late.
Northwestern's had pretty good success right over the middle where the linebackers are going to end up in coverage. And you see Mayfield make this catch in front of Jerry Medved, who got a good drop, actually maybe dropped a little bit too deep on that play, and there's a penalty flag on the sideline.
We'll check this one out as well.
Personal foul against Northwestern State.
So that'll back it up a little bit. Dan Malcolm on the right in the red. He's our red cap here. And of course, Ron Stevenson, the commissioner of the Big Sky Conference, to his left. Dan, an official with the Big Sky Conference. And he's the guy that calls our TV timeout for us. And he didn't want to wear a red cap, so we went out and bought him a nice red sweater. There you go. That's the guy that the officials look to, and if there's a timeout to be called, he will be the one that tells us whether we get it or not. And it controls everything, and there's Sam Goodwin right now.
He's out of control.
What's going on? Yeah. Give me a break here. At any rate, the ball's all the way back to the 44-yard behind. Stoker. Brought down by Zeller. The first sack of Stoker.
Said at the start of the game that Marvin Washington was the guy to watch, number 90. Marvin hasn't had much chance to get to Stoker today. With all that play action, that's pretty hard on the defensive line. You see Zeller just work off of his block and make that sack.
Loss of a little bit more. Second down and 30, back at the 48. Clock running. 11-point ball game. Settling down here a little bit now to a normal football game. Stoker. Washington fumbles the football. Recovered by Northwestern State, Jeff Steers, the senior from Pineville, got in there and got it back. It'll be fourth down, or rather third down. And there's a Vandal getting up real slow.
Marvin must have heard us because as soon as we call his name, he decided it was time to get in on the action. And watch him come off that right end. He's working there off the block of Jay Anderson, just turns back in and strips the ball out of there. And Mike Zeller, who gets hit here at the end of the play, he's walking off the field now, but he was the injured Vandal.
So he's all right, just shook up, but Jeff Steers with Johnny on the spot to make the fumble recovery. Ball at the 45-yard line. Now it'll be third down and 38 to go. The ball at the 45-yard line. See if they got a 38-yard play in their book. Shuffle pass to Paul Frazier. Won't go for 38 maybe, but it's going to go for a few to the 45 of Idaho. A pickup of 10, and that'll be fourth down and 28 now.
The Vandal defense certainly will be more than happy to let them have that play. That's not going to get 38 yards. Of course, with guys like Frazier and DeWitt and those kind of people in the backfield, if you can get him in the open territory, hey, that speed may work, but that's a tough situation for any offense to be in, even the Vandal offense with as many long-distance plays as they have in their playbook.
Mark Contreras comes on to kick it away. Brian Smith will be deep for Idaho. And check that, make it Richard Carey. He'll watch it go. They took the one-yard line on a fair catch. I thought he was going to watch it go into the end zone and just fake the fair catch. And the Vandals will have it at the one. A mistake by Richard Carey. A mistake the Demons will welcome at this point with 4 minutes and 48 seconds to go in the first half.
Well, obviously, Richard Carey must have lost sight of where he was on the field. I'm sure Keith Gilbertson's not real happy with her catching the ball on the 2-yard line. And I think Richard's thinking to himself right now, oops, I'm inside the 5.
I thought I was at the 12.
I've got a problem here.
Yeah.
And now Keith Gilbertson has a problem because he's going to find Carey on the sideline.
Now John Freeze, now 11 of 12 passing for 202 yards. He was 10 of 10 for 200 yards in the first quarter. So, you know, finally he's quieted down. You can't do much when you're at the 2-yard line. Damon Daniels, the hop, skip, and a jump to the 7.
Yeah, it's awful difficult to try and throw the ball out of your own end zone. Too many bad situations happen back there, so the better part of valor says just get yourself some room. Old Sam, he's working that sidelines over, isn't he?
Well, his team's finally back in it, down by 11. He's got a good seat. The last two times Idaho's had the football, they've had it inside their own 10-yard line. And he'd like to make something happen here. Trips coming to the near side on a 2nd down and 5.
Up the middle, Renee Barton. Barton has the first down to the 17, maybe the 18-yard line.
Renee Barton pressed into duty because of Devon Pierce being out with a knee injury. You see the little inside trap play, a little quick hitter. And Renee Barton got to that hole awfully quick. Good timing.
Gain of 11 yards, first down.
11-yard gain for Renee Barton. First down at the 18. 3:50 to go, first half. Freeze to Barton again. Barton, close to another first down.
Have to give Greg Hale, number 70 for Idaho, an assist on that play. Barton ran right up his back. And again, Barton on just a blast play right up the middle. And Hale took a little bit of the brunt of that tackle.
Kevin Lewis makes the stop. It is the first down, so a gain of 10 and a half. So 2 carries and 21 yards here for Renee Barton. He's out of the ball game. Damon Daniels back in. First down from the 29. Freeze back to the passing attack. Gets hit. Ball is knocked down by Lewis. Freeze got a lot of pressure that time from Mitch Rowe. Rowe's already caught him once. And the ball is knocked down by Lewis. So it'll be 2nd and 10.
The Demons have gotten Freeze a little bit in the second quarter. We saw the first quarter. Nobody got near him. Didn't even lay a hand on him. Second quarter, he's been sacked once. He's been bounced around a little bit in that pocket, so got to credit that Demon defense for finding a way to get to John Freeze.
Trips to the near side, and John Freeze audibling at the line of scrimmage. John Jake comes in a little bit closer this time. Freeze. Quick pass for 9 yards. I believe that's Scott Dahlquist, who's getting up slow again.
He took a real good hit at the end of this play. What John Freeze did there is he read the blitz. And you see the linebackers coming for Northwestern. Watch the hit that Dahlquist takes her right at the end of the play. That helmet right in the ribs. Good clean tackle, but that hurts.
Well, that was an interesting play to have the tight end that far split.
Well, you saw John Jake come into the formation, close that formation down. What he was doing is Freeze read the defensive front as a blitz front, called his next outside receiver in to pick up the blitz man. It worked pretty well. Dawkins, watch that helmet go right into the ribs. There's kind of a dead spot there, an open spot in the shoulder pads right underneath the ribs in that area. You see the quarterbacks wearing those big flak jackets now to protect that area because they're exposed a lot more than a tight end would be. But that's a tough place to have a helmet land.
Well, Tracy Palmer was the one who came in and made the hit. And, of course, with both of these teams still possibly looking at 2 more games down the road, injuries really become a key as you go into the playoffs. You're into your 13th game of the season. You're looking at a 15-game season. It's tough. It's like playing in the NFL.
These 1AA playoffs have been criticized for that by a lot of different people. A lot of coaches don't like that situation of having to have a team play 14 games, 15 games possibly if you go all the way. Actually, I think really is too many games to play. There has been talk of knocking the field down to 18. in the playoffs. Obviously, you want to try to get a lot of people involved with it, but when you do the bracket system like the 1AA playoff is set up, it's hard on a team by the time they get all the way to the finals.
Third down and one is the situation. Damon Daniels may have slid in there the second time. Good penetration by the Demons, but Daniels, I believe, has the first down. And they may measure this one. Keith Gilbertson came out. He wanted to make sure of the spot.
He's going to question the spot, too. Neither of these coaches afraid to express their opinion.
No, not at all. Very animated coaches. And at this time, you know, in the season, it's time to get animated, folks, because you're looking at a national championship possibility. We'll check the measurement. So the Vandals will have the first down with 2:48 to work with here in the first half and a 28-17 lead. Daniels, I think, got hit and then slid for the first down right there. Lee Allen comes to the near side. Freeze. Boy, the Vandals picked up the blitz and the ball was tipped. Andre Carraran, I think, may have tipped that ball. They had everybody coming, the Demons did.
Second down at 10.
John Freeze has John Jake heading over the middle, and he's isolated on a linebacker, number 57, Freddie Wallace. And he's going to try and give me the ball, but you see the tipped ball right there. Actually, Steve Compton also on the coverage there, but there was a little hold.
Second down and 10 at the 39-yard line. Freeze again, just a straight drop back. More pressure. They throw complete. Chris Slater, the tight end, for a first down at the 43-yard line.
Northwestern has been sending six, seven guys almost every play. They think that this blitz is the way to attack John Freeze, and it's worked fairly well, but this time they get the ball off to Slater, who's covered by Steve Compton again.
First down after that gain of 18. John Freeze continues to rack up the passing yards. Damon Daniels in motion. Again, more blitz. Underneath to David Jackson, it's complete. Randy Hilliard on the coverage. Oh, he just wrestled him down like he was bulldogging in a rodeo. But it's a gain of about 7 yards.
John Freeze, I think, expects the blitz every play. Now you see just a short three-step drop here. And those are the kinds of plays that you want to have in effect when the blitz is coming. Something quick that you can get off to a hot receiver. You saw the in route there by Jackson, and that's the exact play you want to run in a blitz situation.
Well, it's interesting to see the philosophy here. Freeze, ball was nearly tipped. Lee Allen has it. I believe that was a tip ball. You saw Lee Allen have to make an adjustment, but he catches it for a first down with 1:22 to go. First half.
Let's see if somebody does get a hand on this ball. Yeah, it was tipped there by a linebacker coming in on the play. We couldn't catch his number. But a great reaction there by Lee Allen. That's a very difficult play for a receiver to make.
So the ball's at the 31-yard line. And it's going to be first down. Idaho taking a timeout here. They've got two left. The Demons have three, and it'll give us a chance to tell you that already today, Furman has beaten Marshall 13-9. So the winner of this game will play Furman. And we are told by a couple of three sources that the game will be played at Furman. We'd have to double check that. That's not official by any stretch of the imagination. And also today, Eastern Kentucky beat Western Kentucky 41-24. They'll play Georgia Southern in the other semifinal game. Georgia Southern beating Stephen F. Austin 27-6. And again, we'd like to welcome everybody that is along our network line today. Those of you watching in Shreveport on KTAL, also in Alexandria on KLAX, in Idaho Falls, and Pocatello on KIFI, and in the Boise area on KIVI. Three, stepping up in the pocket, looking for Lee Allen. Allen has it, and he's in for the touchdown. A 31-yard touchdown pass to Lee Allen.
Randy Hilliard was on the coverage that time. Lee Allen, so shifty. hard to keep that guy in the open field under control. Too many moves, too much quickness. And a great pass by John Freese right on the money to the wide open Allen.
So John Freese, another touchdown pass in this ball game.
You can see why John Freese has been the most valuable player of the year in this conference.
Freese, 14 of 19 for 272 yards. Three touchdown passes already. And Payne Doyle will kick it through for the extra point. Well, that's something that the Demons did not need to have happen. With a minute 15 to go in the first half, to have Idaho score, make it 35-17.
Obviously, during that timeout, there was a play design that John Freese and the offensive coordinator talked it over. They figured, hey, this will work. And they came right out and ran it to perfection. Lee Allen with the big catch down in the corner.
John Freese, now that was his fourth touchdown pass. He's just been racking up so fast, I can't keep track of it.
Need a IBM computer to keep track of this guy. But that's just a great throw. And that ball travels a long ways because he's thrown it all the way across the field right into that corner. That's a difficult pass. But John Freese has a very strong arm to go along with being a smart quarterback.
Now the Vandals jump to a 28-3 lead after the first quarter. Saw that evaporate a little bit to 28-17 and a big touchdown there. 11 plays, 98 yards. I forgot that drive actually started at the two-yard line. And Lee Allen with the touchdown. He now has four receptions today for 75 yards and two touchdowns.
Love to be a receiver in this Vandal offense. Everybody gets a piece of the action.
Demons got in trouble with three first-quarter turnovers. Al Edwards taking it inside the five. Look at him go. He's got one, two men to beat and gets caught from behind by Brian Smith. Well, he may have beaten those one or two men. He's at the 48-yard line.
If there's anybody that's going to be able to catch Al Edwards, it would be Brian Smith because he's probably as fast as anyone on this Vandal ball club. And these kickoff returns, we've seen the Vandals all year have trouble with the kickoff return. A lot of people have returned balls for a lot of yardage. This one goes for 44 yards on the return.
7 to go. Let's see what the Demons do here. They've got Floyd Turner coming to the near side along with Mayfield. If they'll keep that offense wide open, as I assume they would, why not? Stoker back to pass. Looking for Al Edwards. Complete at the 35-yard line. That'll be a first down. Gain of about 16 yards.
These teams are going to have their 400-yard average total offense before halftime at the rate this game's been going.
Hurry up offense, no huddle for Stoker and company. The Demons looking at 59 seconds. They do have all three of their timeouts remaining. Edwards again. And Edwards will get close to another first down at the 25. He'll be about a foot shy. Let's see if they have to use the timeout here. As I say, they have all three timeouts remaining.
Stoker now going just to the straight drop back. And Edwards is receiver of choice on these two plays.
So I don't think that Northwestern State wanted to take a timeout, but it took them too long to get that play set up, so they did use one of their three timeouts. With 41 seconds to play, first half, 35-17 Idaho. We've got timeouts, and Stoker's come over to talk to Sam Goodwin and his coaches. But they've moved down the field very quickly, thanks to a 44-yard kickoff return, and it's been the Al Edwards show here.
They've had a very good game plan coming into this game. It's worked well for them offensively. Take away those turnovers in the first quarter, and we've got a different ball game on our hands here.
Oh, no doubt about it. As we mentioned, that stat that was really telling in the first quarter, Idaho came out of it with 223 total yards, and the Demons with 174. So, yet it was 28-3 after that quarter. So it was obvious that the three turnovers really killed the Demons in that first quarter.
Had to give the Vandals a big lift here, too, to drive 98 yards and stick the ball in the end zone. They were getting to a point where they were a little flat on the offensive side of things.
Stoker now not having a bad day here. I guess he likes being indoors again. This is the first time, by the way, Northwestern State has ever played indoors, and Stoker is 15-17 for 203 yards.
Well, we're so used to it here in the Big Sky Conference.
Exactly.
Because there's three domes here in this conference. Three domes, actually, if you count the one down in Flagstaff. Pocatello also with the dome where the NCAA 1AA final championship game will be played on December 17th. We get used to it here, but that doesn't happen very often.
Stoker rolling to his right. Al Edwards was wide open, dropped it. John Place was on the coverage, and I guess they're going to Al Edwards here. That was the fourth time in a row that number eight was called.
Al had been a little quiet earlier in the game, and they've been getting the ball to Mayfield. Throwing to DeWitt out of the backfield, so Edwards, maybe time for him to work his way into this game.
Idaho Band's getting kind of anxious. They want to get out there. They got 37 seconds to wait to get out there. We'll take a look at them a little bit at halftime. But there's 37 seconds to go here in this first half. It's 35-17. Here's a third down play. Orland Lockhart with a great catch and a first down to keep the drive alive. It'll stop the clock momentarily with 31 seconds.
Lockhart looks a little unorthodox.
Now he's down again.
In the way that he does things, he's stumbling around here, the one-hand grab, he brings it in. And he takes a good hit from Jerry Medved and Roger Cecil there at the end of that play.
First down.
Lockhart is the player on the turf right now. Again, this is the second time we've seen this.
He gets the Purple Heart Award after this game's over.
One thing that the coaches were upset about with the field, and we get used to it, so we don't know. They said this was a really hard turf, the hardest one that they've ever seen. And that time, I think that's exactly what happened. Probably the ball and Lockhart and the turf all came together at the same time. If you've ever had anybody just push your stomach in when you're not expecting it, you know, you just lose your air, you can't get it.
And contrary to popular belief, most AstroTurf fields are hard.
Yeah, they really, well,
this one being extremely hard.
You saw what happened to the ball went right up in his belly and displaced all the air that he had. So he'll be fine. It just takes you a minute.
That's the second time that's happened to him today. He was on the oxygen a little bit earlier trying to regroup and regather himself.
He's going to get hooked on that stuff.
Maybe it's laughing gas. I don't know.
31 seconds to play here in the first half. Northwestern State trying to get back on the scoreboard and answer that touchdown the Vandals scored a moment ago. Vandals, every time they seem to get a commanding lead, the Demons come back to try and make a game of it. Stoker with the cutback. Down to the five. It'll be a first and goal to go with 22 seconds to play first half. Great move by Stoker. He's not big. We told you he's only 157 pounds soaking wet. But look at this.
Hey, looks like he might be a quarterback of a Pop Warner team, but a lot of heart underneath that little body and some real good football instincts, too. Great little scrambler.
One timeout left for Northwestern State. They've just taken that. They got one more timeout. 22 seconds to go here in the first half.
Well, if they can stick the ball in the end zone here, it'll be a big moral lift to them going into the locker room.
Oh, no doubt about it.
You know, you take a look at being 18 points down, and they've got themselves back into this game once, cutting the lead down to 11 points. If they get it in here, they'll do the same thing, and at least you're going to have a little better situation in that locker room and know that you're still in the ballgame.
You can set your whole offense up more with what your original game plan was, which is working. The game plan worked in the first quarter, aside from the turnovers.
I think they're throwing the ball probably a little more than what they like to. But still, when you're down by 18 points, you've got to get the thing moving, and that ground game just chews up too much time.
One philosophy that I find interesting is that everybody that has played Idaho this year, for the most part, has abstained from blitzing Idaho because John Freese can hurt you so much. Yet, here in the last quarter, it's been Blitz City for the Demons.
And it worked pretty well, but the field position was horrible for Idaho in the first part of the second quarter. I don't think the blitz is really working. So they may have to revamp that game plan.
Okay, here we go. First and goal to go from the five. 22 seconds left to go in the first half. The pitch out to Kenneth DeWitt, and he's got the touchdown. Great, impressive drive. It started with Al Edwards returning the kickoff 44 yards out to the 48-yard line. Three consecutive passes to Edwards, and finally a big play by Lockhart on a third down, and now the touchdown by DeWitt.
Now here's a situation where Stoker pitches the ball real quickly. Almost may have been a design play that they knew the ball was going to be pitched, and it worked pretty well.
35-23 with 17 seconds to go. Hotnett comes on for the extra point attempt. And he hits it. So 35-24. That's not bad. 59 first half points. You predicted that, didn't you?
Yeah, you know, you never know about this game of football. You always know that Idaho's going to put some points up on the board. That's kind of a given. Northwestern, on and off this year, have scored a lot of points. And then they've had some close ball games with low-scoring games. So, again, you just are never sure how this thing's going to work out. But there's not a whole lot of defense being played here today.
Well, this is so tough to defend, too. DeWitt gets outside. He just makes a real good move there. Rudis has him by the feet but can't bring him in.
There's a great block on the corner man, too. Pat Prince was coming up from that corner position and got a crushing block to knock him down. And that's the situation, again, where they've lost contain on that outside play. You just can't do it. You've got to have someone come up and force that play back to the middle where all your help is.
Well, this first half obviously ain't over yet, as they say. 17 seconds to play. Hotnett will kick it off, and you'll have Brian Smith and Richard Carey deep.
Go, Devos! Go, Hotnett!
That's Richard Carey, number one, nearest to you, and Brian Smith. Demons talked it over to decide what to do here, and I think the Vandals will be looking for just about anything. That's a low one. Renee Barton, good hands at the 37-yard line, and Barton will have it at the 40 with 14 seconds to go. So now, let me ask you the old proverbial question. What do you do with 14 seconds? Do you try to put some more points on the board and just get out of here and be happy with a lead of 11 points?
Well, if a trigger man like John Freeze, I would never say ice the ball, because there's, and no pun intended there, Freeze. I get it, Wayne?
I get it.
I'd say go for it. The way the kid can throw the ball, the kind of receivers he's got, take a shot at it.
Well, Dennis Smith, the free safety, is 10, 20, 30 yards off the line of scrimmage. So I think he's probably playing that possibility. Damon Daniels comes into the ball game. John Freeze with 14 seconds to work. He's going to throw it. Thistle with a good rush. And Freeze throwing it underneath. Complete for the first down to John Jay. That'll stop the clock with 8 seconds to play. And Idaho looking to call a timeout. They have two more.
This time Northwestern goes into the prevent. A little bit of pressure applied there by Sidney Thistle. There's that out route, comeback route to the sideline. Almost impossible to defense if the receiver runs the route right. It's just a very, very impossible play. Sam Goodwin there motioning the little holding call. He'd like to see that happen maybe more than it has. We've only seen one holding call against Idaho today. There you see it again. He's trying to get their attention. Let them know that his boys are being held.
Well, they're playing out all the strategies here in the first half. 8 seconds to play. 35-24 is our score. The Vandals lead it. And the Vandal band says, well, if we can't get out onto the field, we're going to play on a sideline. The winner to play Furman. Beating Marshall today in a quarterfinal game, 13-9. That game was played at Marshall. And Eastern Kentucky beating Western Kentucky. They'll play Georgia Southern in the other semifinal game next week.
And Furman, coming into that game, was the number 4 seed in this playoff format. So they're a team to be reckoned with.
Out to David Jackson with 3 seconds to go, out of bounds. So the battle's down to the last play of the first half, barring any penalties or anything like that.
This is Hail Mary time. Just send all your fast little Smurf receivers, as they call them here at Idaho. Send them down to the end zone and let Johnny Freeze air one out. See what happens. Here they come.
They're going to bring triple receivers to the near side. 3 seconds to go in the half. Freeze getting pressure. Throwing into the end zone. It's going to be intercepted by Dennis Smith in the end zone to end the first half. So
a glimpse of Northwestern State University.
Things happening here. In 2 years, I'm to Dr. L. Austin's tutorial tip that would never have happened anyplace else. We liken it to a miracle. We think that what he has done has been a miracle here.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy.
If any indication of the situation here that's changing, this fall term at Northwestern is the first time you can't find a place to park.
Don't worry. Be happy.
It's wonderful to be at Northwestern this particular year because those things really are in evidence. Our parking lots are full. We had a gathering for the governor yesterday, and the energy, enthusiasm, and vitality of the student body that was gathered for him was remarkable. It warms the cockles of one's heart. It's been around for a while.
It's incredible to see the things that have happened in the 5 years that I've been here. I think probably 5 years ago, we were certainly at the lowest university had ever been, and these past 3 years have just been wonderful. It's been so great to work here and be a part of this.
Don't worry, be happy. Ain't got no place to lay
your... It's been exciting. It's been 12-hour days, 7 days a week. But there has been a commitment on the part of everyone on this campus to see it happen. And when we had our orientation open day ceremonies and there was no room in the auditorium, the faculty had to stand. That is exciting. And it's thrilling to have the students' parents call us and say, my kid's never been happier. You know, he won't come home.
Don't worry.
Western State University in Natchitoches, Louisiana. Right now, the Demons trailing the Idaho Vandals by a score of 35-24 here at halftime. University of Idaho, located in the Palouse country of northern Idaho. Moscow, Idaho is the name, celebrating its 100th year of existence. Let's take a look at the campus of the University of Idaho.
This is the University of Idaho, founded nearly 100 years ago. Committed to serving the people of the Gem State, the University of Idaho provides instruction, research, and outreach programs in every part of the state, teaching future leaders, exploring the mysteries of the world around us.
Hey, the Demons trying to catch up here, and both teams doing a pretty good job of that, because at one point, Idaho led it 28-3 after the first quarter. Wayne DeZubak along with Larry Pulowski. It has been a wild first half. We've got some highlights for you. And I tell you, the Vandals, after getting down 3-0, just exploded, and for a while it looked like it was going to be an Idaho rout. But the Demons have turned it around.
We had to send out the Radio Shack to get more tape to get these highlights because we had quite the offensive output by both teams. Over 300 yards in total offense for each team.
Well, Hotnet right here will get things going off to what seemed to be a normal start, you know, after a nice pass down the middle. And then all of a sudden, things just exploded. John Freese had 200 yards passing in the first quarter alone.
John Freese finds John Jake, his favorite receiver all year long, in the back of the end zone. A little busted coverage there by the Demons.
And that made it 7-3. The big difference in the first half was turnovers.
Well, when you give a team like Idaho the ball three times in your own end of the field, you're going to be in big trouble there. That ball was spotted back where the fumble occurred, but it did result eventually in another Idaho touchdown.
It did indeed, and again it was John Freese and company coming back. Bruce Harris, who may have gotten hurt, may have been put out of this game on this play right here. Watch him get bent over at the very end of the play. We haven't seen him since that touchdown, and that made it 14-3, and then here, lightning strikes again. DeWitt trying to get the handle, can't find it. Richard Carey recovers it for Idaho. That put the Vandals in pretty good position again, although they did have a 15-yard personal foul penalty. They brought it back to midfield, but with John Freese, 50 yards is nothing, and he just takes care of it.
Watch the move here that Lee Allen puts on. Boom. See ya.
Yeah, Dennis Smith didn't know what to do there, and Lee Allen goes in, and all of a sudden this game's looking like a rout for Idaho. And again, Stoker, he had a pretty good first half. This is a fumble recovered by Idaho. The Vandals get it back. And again, you've got another turnover and another problem. So the Vandals come back and score one more touchdown here. John Jake, his second touchdown reception, wide open. And at this point, we're looking at a blowout. But the Demons come right back, much to their credit,
You know, they've got over 300 yards in total offense in this game, as do the Vandals.
Now, they came into this game 10-2. When you win 10 games in the season, you don't win 10 because you played easy teams all year long, and you had some adversity, and they've overcome that adversity and overcome the three turnovers to at least be within striking distance right now.
That's right. That pass to DeWitt closed it down a little bit, and they're going to close it down even more here. Al Edwards in the end zone, wide open. Bingo, and now it's an 11-point ball game, and that's exactly where we're at now, an 11-point margin, albeit two more touchdowns had to be scored. This touchdown pass going to Lee Allen.
Lee Allen, hard to cover, one-on-one. I don't care who you are.
And then one more touchdown coming up here. And bingo, in the end zone goes DeWitt for his second touchdown again. I think the big stat, Idaho, 330 yards in total offense. Ready for the kickoff for the second half. Wayne DeZubak, Larry Pulaski, we're ready to go. Hot net will kick it off, either Brian Smith or Richard Carey. Richard Carey comes up to it, greets it at the 12-yard line. Carey with a burst of speed, out to the 35. So a 23-yard return for Richard Carey. That's been his average all year long.
Well, let's see if the Vandal offense picks up where it left off. John Freese, 17 of 22 for 284 yards and four touchdowns. No, that's not a game. That's just the first half.
Triple wide receivers to the near side. Damon Daniels, the lone setback. And the tight end is Chris Slater, split out to the left. So a little bit different formation than the Vandals have shown all year long. Damon Daniels carries some people out to the 41-yard line. Freddie Wallace made the stop. He's out of Wadewater, Texas.
Daniels had 21 yards on five carries in the first half. And Vandals coming out, trying to establish that running game a little bit here in this first series.
Trips to the near side on the second down and five. Three fumbles the football, falls on it, loses 5 yards, so it'll be third down. Freeze doing all he could, and a very rare mistake by John Freeze.
Ball comes out right after the snap, just never had it when he came out of the center, and being a smart quarterback, as we alluded to earlier, he just falls on the ball, doesn't try to pick it up and make something happen.
Third down and seven with a loss of two. Freeze again, only a three-man rush this time, so he has all the time in the world to throw it. Throwing it, complete. Boy, when you give John Freeze that much time, look out, and that pass was all the way and complete to David Jackson.
Great adjustment by David Jackson, too, to get back to the ball. The ball was underthrown. Freeze had to lay it over the top of one defensive back and in front of the cornerback. And it's a little low, but watch the comeback here, and if he throws it any lower, he's in a big problem there. It could be picked off, but David Jackson does a great job in getting back to the ball.
29-yard gain, first down, ball at the 34-yard line of the Demons.
Go, go!
Damon Daniels, cut back. Daniels for 8 yards to the 27.
This is some real nice hard running by Daniels, but you have to look at the hole that he's got to run through. After he gets by that first diving, lunging tackle, he's got a pretty good-sized hole to hit.
Leonard Parker, leading tackler for the Demons, makes the stop. But now it'll be second down and two at the 26-yard line. Renee Barton goes in motion. Over the middle, Jake, incomplete, almost picked off on the run by Steve Compton, the junior from Dallas.
Dangerous place to overthrow the ball. When that happens in the middle of the field, there's normally a lot of people floating around waiting for something like that to happen. This ball is almost picked off by Compton, but Jake, really not too much of an effort there to get up and get that ball. That shoulder may still be bothering. He banged that up a couple of weeks ago in Boise, and it still is not 100%.
Vandals, by the way, really down to two good running backs right now, Damon Daniels and Renee Barton. Bruce Harris has not been back out. Damon Daniels back up the middle. Down to the 16-yard line for a first down.
Well, you have a guy running like this guy's running, you don't need too many more running backs.
Damon Daniels really coming out and establishing his running game and that Vandal offense. Nice little cutback run in the middle. Again, that offensive line giving him some room.
Daniels gets a breather. Renee Barton checking in. Keith Gilbertson there on the sideline. He just shuffles a lot of people back and forth. Very complicated offense. Very effective offense. Renee Barton. Apparently they found something right smack dab up the middle. Barton goes for 11 to the 4-yard line. First and goal to go.
Well, that's a trap play right up the middle. Let's see who the trappie is. I think it was Mitch Rowe, number 87. See the little inside pull there? It's a cross block almost, not really a trap. But that's a huge hole for Renee Barton. Didn't have to worry about finding that one.
Now right now the Vandals keeping it on the ground, which is not too bad because that first half took forever to play. Trips to the near side on first and goal. Freeze. Throwing, incomplete. I'm not sure who was intended for. Lee Allen was there, and so was Michael Davis.
John Freeze over talking to one of the officials. I'm not sure exactly what he's trying to impart there. Lee Allen ran a stop route at the goal line, and John Freeze threw 5 yards into the end zone, so somebody was confused.
Second and goal from the 4-yard line. Freeze always directing traffic out there. Sends Casey Dunn in motion. Play action fake. Very seldom do you see Freeze roll, and he goes just out of bounds because you are very seldom going to see John Freeze run the football. And if that play, Larry, doesn't work right off the bat, forget it.
Now, that's just a quick pop pass. They want to hit that receiver, and I think Casey Dunn was probably the intended receiver. And boy, sprint out pass from John Freeze. You better keep that one on tape because you might not ever see that again.
Third down and goal. But this time they're back at the 7-yard line. So a loss of 3 yards. Big third down play here for the Demons. Split backfield. Again, a different formation than we've seen here all day today. And Freeze, just a straight drop back. Looking for Jackson. Can't find the handle. The pass was there, Jackson was there, but pretty good coverage nonetheless. Getting over there was Randy Hilliard.
I think Hilliard might have got a piece of that ball, or at least got his hands up to block the vision of David Jackson, because it was a fairly well-thrown ball. Again, this is a play where they throw to an area, and the receiver needs to run under the ball. And watch right at the end there.
Yeah, he did. He knocked it away. Got the whole thing. Great play by Hilliard. And Payne Doyle will set it up at the 13-yard line. 23-yard field goal attempt. Steve Nolan, the holder, the backup quarterback. Thane Doyle's kick is good. So from 23 years out, Thane Doyle hits. And it is now Idaho 38, Northwestern State 24. Stay with us. Increase the Vandals' lead a tad, 38-24 now. Wayne Dizu back along with Larry Pulaski. Welcome to the Kibbe Dome in Moscow. This is the last quarterfinal game to be decided here today on a playoff Saturday in 1AA football. The winner to take on Furman. Eastern Kentucky and Georgia Southern will play in the other semifinal game. They've already won today, all three of those teams. Furman beating Marshall in a close one, 13-9. Moves over at the 5-yard line. Smith waits for a wall and then says, "No, I'm not going to wait any longer. I want to go. Let me loose." And he's out to the 49-yard line. So Dennis Smith with a great return again. This junior from Elm Grove, Louisiana.
45-yard return to the 49.
This is the long way to get there, too. Dennis Smith takes the long route, cuts out to the left, finds a huge, huge hole. Again, the Vandals break down on that coverage, kickoff coverage team.
Another 44-yard return, the second 44-yard return we've seen today. And again, the Demons have great field position. They just go a straight eye, pitch out to Kenneth DeWitt, and DeWitt gets about a yard and a half.
DeWitt has a lot of speed. A junior, he's from Mansfield, Louisiana. 5'9", 177-pounder. A look into the defensive huddle on the sideline of the Demons. Randy Thistle getting some instructions on how to get to John Freeze.
A lot of people have gotten those instructions over the course of this year.
Scott Stoker. Yeah. He made a decision to go up, and Medved was there.
Mike Zeller.
Zeller. And there was nothing but black jerseys.
Little counter option play. They make the counter fake. Quarterback spins all the way around, and this time when he spins around, he has a nightmare on Elm Street waiting for him.
Third down and 10. 10 minutes to play here in the third quarter. 38-24, Idaho leads the Demons. The Vandals fell behind 3-0 and then made it 28-3, and it's been back and forth ever since. Stoker, incomplete, intended for Mayfield, and Mark just dropped it. It'll be fourth down, and Mark Finferris will come on to kick it away. I believe this is only his second punt of the game. Richard Carey drops back in single coverage for the Vandals on a fourth down 10.
Richard Carey, the leading punt returner in the Big Sky Conference this year, dangerous guy back there, and he'll take a lot of chances. He doesn't like the fair catcher. It's a fake.
It's a fake. They get it out to O'Neill, the fullback. And O'Neill is caught well short of the first down. It's a 47-yard line. He needed 10. He only got 5. Mark Contreras turns punter, turns quarterback.
You don't see the fake come off of this play too often. A lot of times it just takes too long to develop. If a team has a punt block on, that play will work a lot better. Idaho had their return on, which meant that they had some guys spying, and they didn't get the coverage they needed.
38-24, our score. We'll be back. Guarded secret. Have you heard attendance at all?
No, no.
The ball in pretty good field position at the 46-yard line. Demons tried the fake punt, didn't work, so the Vandals will start in great territory. Hand off to Damon Daniels, fumbles the football. Daniels looked like he may have fell on it and recovered it and gained 2 yards to boot. Let's wait and see. There are a lot of white jerseys there, but the Vandals did get it.
Sure if Daniels ever really had this ball as it goes through the line. Let's see if we can pick it up here. No, he never did. He didn't have his arms open to receive the handoff properly.
Second down and 7.
Idaho crowd watching on here today at the Kibbe Dome. They like the fact that their Vandals are up 38-24, but I guarantee you the Vandal fans do not feel real easy here as the blitz comes. And Freeze, bothered by the blitz, underthrows John Jake.
Freeze is down.
John Freeze is on the ground. Sidney Thistle got to him, and he is very slow in getting up. And if you want to hear awake, listen to the crowd now. They're just sitting here watching John Freeze. This could not only mean difficulty for the rest of this game, but if Freeze is gone, it could very well possibly mean a national championship.
They're looking at his ankle. He was caught under a big pile there. His ankle or his knee. And he had a lot of beef on him. And you can see Greg Hale, he doesn't look too happy there.
So there you have it. That's the story on the field. John Freeze is down. Timeout. 38-24. Vandals lead it. Well, there's the story. John Freeze, his right ankle. He leaves having completed 18 of 27 for 313 yards and four touchdowns. Andy Badia comes in, and the crowd trying to give him a lift. Andy has not played a whole lot. The handoff to Renee Barton. Thompson brings him down, but not till he gets to the 48-yard line. And it'll be fourth down for Idaho, and the injury to Freeze does not look good.
Well, he wasn't putting any weight on that ankle at all, so at the very least, it's got to be a very severe sprain. And we'll hope that's as bad as it ends up.
Well, to give you an idea of how tough it is for the Vandals, they go from John Freeze, the veteran, two-time All-Conference, most valuable player of the Big Sky, to a freshman from Pocatello. Yep, you got to have a flag. The Vandals will get the football back. Adrian Howard ran into John Place, and the Demons will not get the football. And there's another big mistake. Call this a turnover, if you will.
Adrian Howard just takes a very bad angle to try to block that punt. That's a costly mistake for this team and ball club because they had things kind of going their way.
Well, it was fourth down and four, so the penalty gives them the first down. Andy Badia comes back in at quarterback.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense. First down.
Here it is.
He's blocked into the punter. There's no problem. Richard Carey does not block him, and he just takes, again, a very poor angle. And big break for the Vandals.
Well, the Vandals will have it at the 32-yard line of the Demons from Northwestern State. John Freeze, by the way, during the timeout when he was helped off the field, drew a standing ovation, as well he should, for the year he's had here at Idaho. And if we get any word, we'll pass it along as to what his situation is. I'm sure he's gone for today. We'll see if that's going to be a situation that may come into effect next week. And I think you see right now a little problem the Vandals are going to have on offense. Badia hasn't been in there that much, and a lot of people jump.
I don't think Badia has taken more than 10 snaps this year.
Have a dead ball, false start, offense.
I thought we might see Steve Nolan in the ballgame. Nolan with a little bit more experience than Badia.
Yeah, he's just a sophomore, though. So you've got a freshman and a sophomore backing up your all-conference MVP. 38-24 is our score. Idaho leads it with 8 minutes and 43 seconds to go in the third quarter. They have a first down, 15 from the 37-yard line. Badia throwing. Wide open, John Jake, first down at the 21.
And that play right there for the young quarterback draws probably the biggest cheer of the day. An incredibly difficult situation. But Badia, we saw him play in a high school game in Pocatello a couple of years ago, and we thought he had some good skills. You see right there, a nice little pass into the seam.
He is a redshirt freshman, so that does make a little bit of difference. He's been in the program for a couple of years, but still, this is a tough spot to come in. Badia. Oh, he gets knocked, and the flag goes down.
You know, if I just lost my first team quarterback, I don't know if I'd be running the option with my second team quarterback.
Holding against Idaho. That'll back it up.
John Freeze is up walking around on the sideline, so we may yet see him back in this game. Badia runs a little counter option here, and he pays the price for it.
Well, we'll
holding offense. First down.
Here's Freeze on the sideline. He just sat back down again on the bench and looking at it. So, well, we know one thing then. Chances are it's not broken, although it could be a hairline.
Sportsmanlike conduct call. I think Keith Gilbertson on the sideline had a few words to say to the official, and the official threw a flag, and you can see it laying right there on the sideline. He didn't like it too much.
Well, that'll back it all the way out to the 46-yard line. Well, we haven't had much happening on the field, but there's been a lot of stuff happening off the field and around the benches and with coaches.
There's a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct, offense.
How about head coach?
Well, I guess he's the head of the offense. It's kind of like being the president, you know.
All right. First down and 35 to go. The ball at the 46-yard line. And Beatty is going to change things up at the line of scrimmage. He sees everybody up there. Got about a nine-man front. Beatty looking. Just overthrows Lee Allen. Hittman on the coverage. But Beatty did a good job. He saw that blitz. He read it and had the right play called.
Quick three-step drop, and he had his widest receiver on a fly route. Just take off towards the end zone. Hope you can outrun it. I'll try to throw you the ball. And again, the philosophy here at Idaho, they want on those deep routes, they're definitely going to overthrow the ball. They're not going to let the thing be short so it has a chance of being picked off. They're going to throw long, so you'll see a lot of overthrowing passes.
Beatty again steps into the pocket. Throws behind his intended receiver, John Jake, and he drops it. It'll be third down.
Yeah, definitely behind Jake. It would have been a great catch if he would have pulled this one in. Here you see it from the end zone camera. He turns his body back around, almost makes the catch, but some pretty decent coverage there by David Chipman to break that up.
Down in 35, still at the 46-yard line. Vandals have been out on offense, it seems like forever here in the third quarter, but nothing's really happened. Beatty, a lot of time to throw, looking for Lee Allen, almost intercepted. Knocked away at the last moment by Dennis Smith.
That's a great reaction there by Smith to get over to that ball. Beatty left it up in the air quite a while, but Smith came over there with a full head of steam.
So John Place now comes in. Final score today in football. Army beats Navy 20-15. John Place, big rush. Gets it off. Down to about the 1 yard line. Matt Clark watched it go out of bounds at the one. The Demons will have the football at the 1 yard line with 7 minutes and 55 seconds to play in the third quarter, trailing by 14, 38-24.
Well, here's where that option offense can really help you out. When you can run the ball between the tackles like this ball club can, that's a big plus when you're backed up to your own 1 yard line.
One thing the injury to John Freese has done is gotten the crowd into the ballgame. They're really loud here right now. It's going to be tough for Stoker to call signals. Fakes over the middle. Orland Lockhart, the tight end. First down to the 21-yard line. A great call by Sam Goodwin of the Demons.
You know, everybody in the world expected the run there, and I can guarantee you Idaho expected it. And that's a gutty play to drop back 5-6 yards into your own end zone and throw that ball out of there. It worked pretty well.
So you get out of trouble real quick. You're at the 22-yard line, and you also take the crowd out of the ballgame for a moment. Down by two touchdowns. Anthony Mason comes to the near side. Stoker. Stoker had an option. He could either run right into Marvin Washington or run away from him, and he took the latter.
Stoker. Jim Rudin stopped him.
Running away from Marvin Washington certainly is the intelligent way to go.
Actually picks up 4 yards doing so, so it'll be second down and six.
A little aerial perspective on how far this Northwestern State team has to go.
Latest update on John Freese, it's an ankle sprain. He's trying to walk on it. He might possibly return. Harris has a knee problem, will not return. Timeout. The Demons of Northwestern State ran out of time on the clock and had to just basically take timeout or take a penalty. 38-24, Idaho leads it. We'll be back in a moment. national championship indeed rides on that ice pack, wrapped around the right ankle of John Freeze, the quarterback, now on the sidelines. Out to Al Edwards. Great move by Edwards. He gets to the 34-yard line and has a first down. So the word we got a moment ago is that John Freeze might return. But I'll tell you what, when you look at it on the sidelines, it's siesta time, and he's keeping that ankle elevated. He's not coming back.
Is there like aspirin or something more powerful that he can ask him if there's something more powerful that I can have.
No? Obviously it hurts.
Can he give me anything?
So John Freeze decked out on the bench. Stoker to Floyd Turner, one-on-one. Tripped up by Richard Carey. Gain of about 4 yards. Great reaction to the ball here by Richard Carey. And again, you're getting it into the hands of a guy that's a pretty fair receiver here in the open field. Great one-on-one tackle. Second down and six. The ball at the 39-yard line. Edwards comes into the play. Mayfield comes out.
They're going to have to get this play off in a hurry. They only have 10 seconds left on the 25-second clock.
They've run that down a couple of times. They had to use one of their timeouts, which may come back to haunt them. Pete Ellis, the fullback, for two. So now they're looking at a respectable third down and three. Minutes, 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter. One thing's for sure, we've been talking to John Freeze, he will not be back in this ballgame because they're not sure what it is yet. We've got a sprained ankle, but nobody really knows. I guarantee you they're not going to chance it. It's going to have to be Andy Badia to lead this team. Meantime, the Demons have a third down and three. Stoker out to Paul Frazier, drops the football. Just as the ball got to Frazier, he looked to see where he was going, and he dropped the football.
Kind of surprised to see the punting team come out, although there is plenty of time left. Still 20 minutes to go in this ball game. But they had the play set up. They had the first down yardage.
Had one-on-one coverage with Medved, the linebacker. It's what you want to do. It just didn't work out, so it's fourth down and three.
It's real frustrating when you have the right play called and it's executed right and you just don't hang on to the ball. That's a tough way to go.
Contreras kicks it away. Richard Carey calls for a fair catch at the 18, and that's where the Vandals will start. Now it'll be interesting to see if Idaho just takes a different approach here, maintains their offense as they would with Freeze in there, or go ahead and try to run the ball a little more. Because remember, they've lost Bruce Harris to a knee injury. He's gone. Lost Evan Pierce last week to a knee injury, so he's gone. Freeze is out. That backfield's taking a big beating right now. Now here we are atop our perch at the Kibbe Dome.
Perch is a good word. We're up here.
First down and 10 from the 18. Damon Daniels, not a whole lot there.
You wonder how much a change in quarterbacks really affects the ball club. You know, I know that Greg Hell was very upset when John Freeze got hurt. Maybe it was his guy that got in on him and eventually made that blow that put him out of the game. But it seems like the whole timber, the whole pitch of their offense has kind of changed here a little bit. They've got to get that momentum back on their side, at least in the way that they think about the game.
Damon Daniels in motion. Badia with a second down and nine. Underneath he throws, and he throws behind Michael Davis. So Davis was open. Newstrom was there on the coverage, but it was thrown behind Davis. It'll be third down and nine.
We saw a lot of blitzing out of Northwestern in the end of the first half. The start of this third quarter, they haven't done too much at all. I'm surprised kind of to see them not try to put a little bit more pressure on this young freshman quarterback.
Well, they may bring it right here on third down and nine. We'll see. This is the place to do it. Trips to the near side. They've run out of time on the clock to get the playoff, so the 25-second clock runs out. The Vandals delay a game. It'll back it up 5 to the 15. Keith Gilbertson feeling more and more uneasy as time goes on here at the Kibbe Dome.
Delay of game, offense, third down.
Third and 14 at the 15. And a new play will come in from Keith Gilbertson. That's our situation right now.
That was the defense.
You're kind of in a little predicament here. Do you pin your ears back and go after the cube, or do you play a little prevent defense and just try to keep them from getting that first down? It looks like they're going to play a little standard defense here.
Now they got some ears coming back. Down at the 5-yard line, Sidney Thistle gets in there and puts Beatty into the turf. Boy, he had his ears pinned back.
He's listed as a linebacker, but the way they play this defense, basically a 5-2 defense, he's rushed most of the day. And he's come off the corner pretty hard. There you see a real tough collar put on by Sidney Thistle.
Well, Badia, I thought, did a good job to hold on to the football because he never saw Thistle come and didn't even hear him. Place. Matt Clark will take it at about the 46-yard line. Stevens looking to get pretty good territory. A flag goes down, and there may be a clip or something against the Demons, which would hurt them again.
It would be unfortunate for Northwestern if it is a penalty because they have themselves set up in some real good field position here.
See if we can see a clip or anything.
That might have been a clip right there on 48 Matt Pancari.
That's going to back the Demons up a little bit more. You're right. So it's not a turnover, but it certainly is a mistake that the Demons cannot afford being down by 14 points.
We have holding on to run back. First and 10.
End result is the same. The ball has moved back to the Demon territory at the 46-yard line. 3 minutes, 36 seconds to play. Third quarter. Vandals lead it 38-24. Stoker to Floyd Turner, complete at the 35-yard line of Idaho. A first down and a gain of 17 yards.
I saw a little quarterback shuffle in the first quarter. Stoker's got the call pretty much though. The rest of the way, the second and third quarters have been all his. And there's a nice little pass to Floyd Turner, who hasn't seen too much action here in the last few minutes.
First down. They hand it off to the fullback up the middle. Ryan Drickskill in the ball game right now, number 38. O'Neill and Pete Ellis have also played that spot here today. He comes out and Pete Ellis comes back in. Gain of 3, maybe 4, second down and 6. High formation. Reverse, they pick it to Al Edwards, trying to get outside. And Edwards trips and falls, trying to make the corner, and is stopped by Brian Smith back at the 33-yard line. Loss of about a yard.
On every play, somebody has responsibility on the backside of the play to watch for reversal. This time it's Roger Cecil, number 43. That's his responsibility. He's the spy. Now, he gets picked off there with the block, but at least he's there enough to slow him down so that he can't turn the corner.
Third down and 7 after a loss of a yard. At the 32 is where they mark it officially. Turner and Al Edwards slip wide to the top of your screen. Mayfield comes to the near side. Silver rolling right. Brian Smith brings him down at the 36-yard line.
Joker just runs out of time and room, and he's got both of his backs out in a out blocking the contain man, so they're not available to be an outlet for him. And he just doesn't have anybody to throw to.
The thing I like about Brian Smith is when you play defensive back, the coach will tell you, if you're going to commit to the run, commit. Don't do it halfway, commit. And you saw Brian Smith that time go 90 miles an hour. He knew exactly that he was going to commit to Stoker as the run and forget the pass. An official, by the way, was kind of shaken up on the play. They're giving him a chance to catch his breath, and you can see him limping there. So everybody's getting injured in this football game. But getting back to that Brian Smith situation in the middle, I mean, he split that puppy right down the center. So now it is 38-27. The margin has narrowed to 11 points. And those who came from Natchitoches, Louisiana, have a little bit more to cheer about. Again, we'd just like to pass a welcome along to all those watching here today. Those watching in Shreveport on KTAL. Those watching in Idaho Falls, Pocatello, and Blackfoot, Idaho. All of Eastern Idaho on KIFI. Those watching in Alexandria, Louisiana on KLAX. And, of course, on the Natchitoches Cable Television Network as well. And on KIVI in Boise. Home of the Palouse Country of Northern Idaho. Just 9 miles from Pullman, Washington, down the road, where Washington State will play in the Aloha Bowl this year. They're ranked 18th in the country. The Vandals rated number one of the all eyes of the Kibbe Dome on number 15, Andy Padia, the redshirt freshman from Pocatello, Idaho, which is, of course, the home of the NCAA 1AA championship game, December 17th. Three teams have advanced to the semifinals. The pass complete to Chris Slater, the tight end. 12-yard gain, first down. Leonard Parker made the stop.
Badia needed that pass real bad to get some confidence back under his belt. He got the one reception earlier, but he's had five passes either thrown behind people or dropped, and that one has got to be a morale booster for him.
Well, that time they brought the pressure again, as you saw, and Badia, very cool. He just dumped it off to the tight end. First down out at the 43-yard line. Damon Daniels trying to cut back, but it wasn't there. Hanging on for dear life was Parker.
Leonard Parker, we haven't talked too much about today. He's leading tackler on this Demon Ball Club.
A senior out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I was talking, it was kind of funny, I was talking to one of the coaches. I said, the last time I was in Baton Rouge was like in the 80s, the early 80s, late 70s. I think 77, in fact, when Nebraska played LSU. And Nebraska was number one in the country, and it was a 6-6 tie. He was at the game. So talk about small world. Adrian, straight dropout.
Oh, my God!
Jumps it out to John Jake. Jake tries to put a move on Parker and gets a couple of more yards. It'll be third down and five.
Stop by Leonard Parker.
Northwestern coaches pleading with the referees, trying to get a holding call.
Third down and five.
Jake, too much move for the turf and shoe cohesiveness.
There's the official that was injured before. He's still walking it off. Third down and five for Idaho at the 48-yard line. Got a nine-man front up there right now. Badia getting all kinds of pressure. He is really racked up back at the 40-yard line. Sidney Thistle was there, but I'm not sure he's the one that really put the hit on. The guy that put the hit on was Brian Guidry, number 62.
That's a situation where a young quarterback just gets a little bit flustered because he knows the blitz is coming. He made the right call, he audible correctly, but he still, you could see, was just a little bit confused and a little bit nervous out there.
So John Place will kick it away to Pat Clark. What a beautiful kick by Place. Clark, back to the 17-yard line. Ripped up at the 17 and stopped right there. So no return on the punt. Good coverage by Idaho. And the Demons will have it at the 17-yard line after a 38-yard kick by John Place.
One of those punts of
about 68 yards rushing.
Great big hole opened up in the middle of that defensive front. Idaho right now, you can just see it in their eyes, at least offensively, they're just trying to hang on. They put a lot of pressure, a lot of weight on the shoulders of this defense.
Ball out to the 38-yard line. Stoker looking for a wide-open Mayfield, has the ball at the 39-yard line, complete. Stopped immediately by John Plate. But it's another first down and a gain of 20.
You see this one coming from a long way off. Mayfield just gets in, seen behind the linebackers, just in between the safety and the cornerback. That's called a seam route. He found the seam in that zone defense.
So you've got all kinds of time in the world. An 11-point ball game, 38-27 with 10:57 to go. Handoff to Kenneth DeWitt. to the 35-yard line. Gain of four. Second down and six. Kenneth DeWitt. I was real impressed with the running he did against Boise State last week. Stoker with a big rush, and that big rush causes him to throw underneath the intended receiver, Anthony Mason.
There was no huddle offense too that time. They were trying to shake up this Vandal defense a little bit and run two plays in succession without going back to the huddle. They have caught the Demons a little off guard themselves.
Well, the Demons have two timeouts left. Idaho has all three of their timeouts. But as you said, if you're looking at it from a Vandal perspective, they want the clock to keep running. They're not in a real good frame of mind right now, having lost threes and things not going very well for them. So it's up to the defense to stop the Demon offense. If that can't happen, Pete Ellis, the fullback, to the 29-yard line, close to a first down. And it looks like they'll mark it where it would be a first down. Take a timeout to measure it anyway. It's going to be very close.
Yeah. Looks like where they have it spotted. He should have it by about half of the football.
Yeah, they're not going to make any mistakes right now, are they? They're going to make sure.
First down.
That was a close one. So with 10 minutes to play here in the ball game, 38-27, Idaho leads it. But you've got the Demons from Northwestern State, from Natchitoches, Louisiana, making a move. Both of these teams looking to advance to the semifinals next week against Furman. Furman has already won, beating Marshall 13-9 earlier today. The pass complete. Out of bounds, rather. They say it was completed to Mayfield, but out of bounds. Charlie Oliver really put a hit on Mayfield and knocked him all the way out to the track.
Stoker hangs this ball up just a little bit too long, puts a little bit too much loft on it. Mayfield has to wait for it to come down. By the time it does, Oliver's already over there with him.
Ball comes back to the 29-yard line. Will it be second down and 10? Al Edwards and Floyd Turner go wide to the top of your screen. Pete Ellis and Kenneth DeWitt are the running backs to the I formation. DeWitt spins, stays on his feet, and gets to the 23.
Roger Cecil put the final hit on there. Some real strong, aggressive running there by DeWitt. Just didn't want to go down.
4 yards.
How many Vandals have a shot at him here?
Third down and 5 yards to go.
Well, it'll be third down and five now. Ball at the 24. Stoker keeps it and gets to the 19. And again, we may be looking at a measurement. He is right there at where he needs to be for a first down. And they're going to stop the clock and bring the chains out.
Leaving themselves much room on these first downs, are they? They're just measuring it right off at 10-yard increments.
Orland Lockhart, you saw him on the sidelines getting some instructions from Sam Goodwin. He'll bring the play in.
Now it's about time that they go to Lockhart. He hasn't been used for about two series now, so I put those linebackers to sleep.
All right, you got a short. So you're looking at fourth down, and maybe that'll change the play, because I'm sure that the coach probably figured this was the first down. And now you're looking at fourth and inches. 9:51 to go in the ball game. 38-27 is our score. The scoreboard pretty much tells the situation. Allison Frazier the setback. And Stoker gets the first down. So get a new set of four downs here. Plenty of time for the Demons to score. They need two scores. They'll obviously have plenty of time to do that if they can get in here. But this is a key offensive series for Northwestern State. Stoker, the handoff. handoff to Frazier. And Frazier kind of ran into some trouble at the line of scrimmage. His own man was laying on the ground, and he couldn't find a way to get around him. That was Big Todd Nunnally.
He'll pick up about four. We've seen Frazier handle the ball quite a bit today. He's been a big part of this offense.
He's just a sophomore from Coushatta, Louisiana. Stoker going to go the other way. Look at this guy go. He could be in. Touchdown. And there's a flag down, so hold it. There is a flag down. Jeff Spears was laying on the flag, and we couldn't see it. So this may not count.
Well, it's the option to the right. A little improvisation here on Stoker's part, and they might have called a clip right there on Rudis. That's a great effort by Stoker, no matter what happens, and they are bringing it back.
What a tremendous effort, but it is not going to count. What a shame for Stoker, because that was a great play.
Clipping, offense, the touchdown.
Against on Younger State.
Boy, he is just so hard to corral, isn't he? Keith Gilbertson gets a breather, because not only does the touchdown come back, but the ball comes all the way back to the 30-yard line. They had it down to the 19. So it's second down and 21 to go from the 30-yard line. Stoker, shuffle pass to Frazier, breaks one tackle. And he is down to the 14, but wait a minute. Another flag goes down. Going to be against the Demons again, I'm afraid.
The shuffle pass. This time Rudis almost gets there to make the play, but it's worked pretty effectively the three or four times we've seen it run this season.
Well, they're talking to Medved, leading tackler for the Vandals of Idaho, and we'll find out what the situation is right now.
Holding, offense, second down.
Now, these are mistakes that if you're a Demon fan right now, you're going to be sitting in neck of this going, I can't believe this. Almost impossible for us to see any kind of an infraction there. So the ball is back to the 27-yard line, where it'll be second down and 18 to go. Here comes Stoker, near side, the pump fake. Getting pressure from the backside. Incomplete pass. Marvin Washington took Stoker down just as Stoker unleashed the football.
Marvin's not very fast, is he? Look at him come all the way from the backside. Stoker doesn't really see him coming. I know he feels him now.
He really
feel that hot breath on the back of his neck.
Incomplete pass.
So it's an incomplete pass. Michael Bailey and Marvin Washington congratulating themselves on that play. But it's still third down and 18 to go. And Orton Lockhart comes in with a play from Sam Goodwin. Stoker, flags are down. The pass knocked away by Charlie Oliver. Incomplete. Now a flag goes down late. There are two flags down.
Well, they're going to call interference on Charlie Oliver, but it's not going to matter because there was illegal motion or illegal procedure on Northwestern State. They didn't get set in their formation. Boyd Turner was out on the left-hand side in the slot, still moving around when the ball was snapped.
So you're going to have offsetting penalties. They'll play it again.
Illegal motion on the offense. Pass interference on the defense. Offset. Replay the down.
Casey just erased that one from the books. Start over.
Bring it back to the 27 and cue it up again. Third down and 18 from the 27-yard line. In the ball game at this point. Stoker letting fly for Turner. Incomplete. A great play by John Clayson, Richard Carey, and a great pass really by Stoker. He hit Turner right on the money.
Richard Carey.
Yeah, some really good coverage here. They're bringing out Hodnett to try what will look like about a 44, 45 yarder.
Just trying to chip away at this lead. I'll place it down at the 34-yard line. 44-yard field goal attempt.
Well, this is, if they can get this through, it'll at least put them in the vicinity for a tie.
Demons look a little bit unorganized there on that field goal team. And the kick by Hotnett is good. And all of a sudden, with 8:14 to go, it is narrowed just a little bit more. We're looking at a 38-30 ball game here at the Kibbe. You've seen the game go from one side to the other. 38-30 is the score. Idaho leads it, but Northwestern State chipping away at the lead. Richard Carey. Straight through a hole. Out to the 42-yard line. Scotty Stoker on the sidelines. What a yeoman's job he's done today. He just, you know, when his team was down 28-3 in the first quarter, there were a lot of people in the Kibbe Dome going, ah, this is a piece of cake game. And Scott Stoker and company have just fought and fought and fought and come back.
Well, he's earned his scholarship today. There's no doubt about it. He's been all over the field and generated some pretty impressive offensive numbers himself.
Again, if you just tuned in, John Freeze, the Idaho quarterback, the All-American. An ankle injury. Could be a bad sprain, could be a break. They don't know. He's out of there. Andy Beatty is in. Damon Daniels trying to run the football. Right now, the Vandals would like to keep the ball on the ground, get about three or four first downs here, and get the clock down to a couple of minutes. John Freeze in the middle of your screen with the crutches.
8-1, second and 9.
They've taken the ice pack off, and he's got a little shoe on there.
Probably taped it up to try to keep the swelling down or keep the swelling out of the joint.
Lee Allen comes to their side along with Casey Dunn. But Andy Badia, just a freshman, hasn't worked that out. Throwing it out to Renee Barton. Barton, another guy who hasn't played much. They lose 2 yards on the play.
Now, these are the positions you can't put the young quarterback in. Badia ended up in third and 12, third and 8. Those are situations that he's just not able to handle right now. You've got to find some way to get this offense cranked up again. To at least get 4 or 5 yards.
Well, the Northwestern State offense sitting there. Mason and Edwards and Floyd Turner. They're waiting for their turn again. They feel like they can get the job done here at the Kibbe Dome today. Badia. Throwing over the middle. Wide open as Jackson drops it. David Jackson was there. The ball was there, but the connection just wasn't made.
Badia shows you a little bit of the arm that he possesses. And this is one of those, just a fraction of an inch, one way or the other. A little less of a throw, a little bit more of a dive. That ball, you know, a difficult catch, but catchable.
So John Place comes in. Nine-man front, but they've got the return on. Pat Clark at the 22-yard line. Pat Clark at the 40-yard line. 18-yard return for Clark. And again, the Demons are looking pretty good on offense. The Vandals come out 1-2-3, and they're back on defense.
Yeah, this is going to take its toll on this defense here real quick, and we may have already seen that. But I've been impressed with both teams' returns all day long. We've seen some great kick returns. Either that or we're seeing some very poor coverage. I don't know which way to go on that.
Northwestern State. And a whistle flies. Now the flags fly, the whistle blows. At any rate, the play doesn't count.
Dead ball, false start, offense.
I think they're trying to set a record for how long they're going to play this game. On your screen, number 70 right there. He just kind of makes a move too early.
Robbie Martin cost him five there.
net. He's kicked a few field goals here today. And these guys are going to start liking to play indoors. The pass is complete. DeWitt. And DeWitt stays in bounds. And after all of that, doesn't gain a whole lot. About a 7-yard gain.
This Idaho defense definitely needs a breather. They haven't got any kind of help at all from that offense since Freeze left the game.
Second down and 8. Al Edwards, you saw, came in for the bench with the play. And Stoker rolling to the near side. Now throws back, complete to Pete Ellis, the fullback, who has a first down at midfield. Medved brought him down. And there's another flag down.
Stoker just finds a way to make things happen. Improvise, stop, roll out, real cool under pressure, and finds enough somehow for the first down.
Well, this time I think it's going to go against Idaho, but the flag is down. The play will stand, and the initial report was clip against Idaho.
Have clipping defense is pushing the back. First down.
That's not legal.
Here it is again. Ellis catches it. There, I think you see the push in the back.
I think if you're trying to tackle a ball carrier, can't you push somebody out of the way to get there?
Yeah, I thought that looked, that one, if that was it, I thought it looked pretty legal. Stoker. Throwing. Incomplete. The ball was caught by Mayfield, but out of bounds. And Stoker again running for his life.
Well, you talk about what two quarterbacks mean to their ball club. Both of these teams we're watching here today live or die with the way that their quarterbacks play. And right now, Idaho's dying because their quarterback's over on the sideline with his ankle all busted up. Northwestern's quarterback's still on the field, and he's doing a heck of a job.
Second down and 10 at the 34-yard line. Handoff, Paul Frazier. He's wrapped up at the 29-yard line. Gain of about 5.
Get a little idea on that play what football sounds like. This is not a, this is a very audio oriented game. There's a lot of sounds that go on down in that field that are pretty interesting to listen to.
Ball at the 28-yard line. Third down, 4 to go. How many times has Northwestern State been in a third down situation like this? They keep coming back, keep coming back. Down by just 8. Frazier breaks it for the first down to the 19-yard line.
The fatigue starting to show on this Idaho defense. They missed 2 or 3 tackles there that they probably would have made a little while ago.
No question about it. And now you get down to crunch time.
You know, last week, Northwestern ran 94 offensive plays against Boise State, 71 rushes. I mean, that is just unheard of.
High formation on a first down from the 18-yard line. 38-30 is the score. Idaho leads it. The pass out to Frazier. And Frazier is put to the ground by Medved at the 18. There'll be no gain on the play.
This time Jim Medved got into the act. We've seen Jerry a couple of times today. And with the Medved brothers, you're safe. Because if you use the name Medved, you're pretty much cover your bases there.
You bet. They're like the first and third leading tacklers on this team. They're all over the place.
Form tackle.
Second down. Ball of 8 to go. Trying to cut against the grain. Moves it inside the 15 to the 13. Third and 3. The clock continuing to run. 3 minutes, 38 seconds to play in the ball game. 38-30, Idaho leads it. And again, you got to be looking at the possibility of going for 2. DeWitt now has carried the ball 11 times for 83 yards, and Frazier 9 times for 68. The pitch out to DeWitt. Flies up and gets the first. So it'll be first and goal to go for Northwestern State.
DeWitt's the guy they really like on this pitch out play down close to the goal. And he finds a way to get the first down and a few more to spare.
So it's first and goal to go at the 7 yard. Looking ahead, if we do have a tie in this ball game, each team would start at the 25-yard line. To play in the game. Scott Stoker down to the four. Second and goal to go. Clock continues to run. 2:45. Idaho with all three of its timeouts left. Northwestern State with two left.
You can just feel it. They're just hanging on. Idaho with their claws to the last inch here.
Demons. Nothing there. Pete Ellis is stopped at the 4 yard line. The Demons obviously feel this is the last time they could score. They feel this is it. If they have a chance, they're looking at overtime. They're letting the clock run, not using their timeouts. It's going to be third down and goal to go. They will go twice from inside the four if necessary.
It's a classic situation. These were one right here on plays like this.
The fullback, Ellis, not there. We'll call a timeout now, I'm sure, to discuss things over. With fourth and goal to go from the five and 1:42 in the ball game, the Demons will talk it over. It's come down to the nitty-gritty of this ball game. 38-30, we'll be back. Much more than what the scoreboard tells you, except to let you know it's fourth and goal to go from the 4 yard line for the Demons of Northwestern State. Not only do they have to score a touchdown right here, then they have to go for the two.
A lot of pressure on this offense because they have to score on two successive plays basically from the 4 yard line now, from the 3 yard line.
They've got a lot of options. That's why they've got an option offense. A lot of weapons. Listen to the crowd. Stoker changing the play. Stoker down at the six. Here it is again on tape.
You call the option. Actually, there was a little illegal procedure to start it off, but just a lot of penetration. And who else but Marvin Washington makes that final sack?
Well, all year long, and now you're in a real...